Chelsea, can we start?
Yeah, we can.
Okay, we start now. It's almost 9. So, Assalamualaikum and good morning to all participants from the MBA Research. We will have two days online training, remote in-house online training on technical report writing workshop. Just a brief briefing on our consultant trainer, Cik Nur Azmi. Sorry, Cik Azmi Sharin. Yes. Mr. Azmi Sharin Abdul Rahim. So he has bachelor degree in accounting and economics from University of Kent, United Kingdom, has also master degree in economics from Mesti Melaya. He is the HRDF trainer and speaker. He also the chief trainer of Club Pidato Perdana and also the distinguished Toastmaster as well. He achieved gold award certificate for it. His expertise are public speaking, communication, interpersonal skill, English language and leadership. He has published a book, English with Azmi. So I stop sharing. Okay, so I pass to Azmi to continue our training. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Puan Marina. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Let's put our hands together to welcome everybody to this program. Tepuk. Okay, I would like to share my screen. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamualaikum. We will be together for the next 2 days, and the topic that we are addressing in the next 2 days is titled Technical Report Writing. Yeah, I understand that all of you are researchers, some junior researchers, some of you are senior researchers. So this is very much to do with the things that you do every day, which is researching and then producing a report to document the thing that you are researching. Okay, my name is Azmi. I will be your trainer, coach, facilitator, and also host, yeah, for this two-day program. I am with Puan Marina. We are from Sirim STS. Okay. And I would like to welcome all of you once more. Yeah. Superheroes of Tenaga Research. Okay. I call all of you superheroes because all of you are the machinery that works for Tenaga Research. Okay. Without you, nothing gets done at Tenaga Research, because the main business, the core business of Tenaga Research is doing research. So you are there as researchers. So I salute all of you. You are all great superheroes. Okay. And I hope that you are enthusiastic and you are excited to be with me to learn, to improve your written output so that your report becomes more valuable. And as a result of that, you also get better career opportunities, upward mobility in your organization. Okay. Jadi saya harap anda semua akan mengikuti kursus ini dengan penuh tumpuan dan juga penuh keterlibatan. Okay. Ini profil saya seperti yang telah dibaca oleh Puan Marina. Saya pernah berkhidmat di Shell sejak tahun 92 selama 8 tahun. Ya, saya memasarkan apa tu bahan bakar industri dan juga bahan pelincir. Yeah, I was marketing industrial fuels and industrial lubricants. My main market at that time was down south in Pasir Gudang. And after that, I joined Maxis. I was the marketing manager for prepaid, which is Hotlink. I was part of the team that launched Hotlink. And then I joined an IT startup company. But unfortunately, the IT startup company didn't succeed. It failed. Okay, so like many startup companies, many startup companies don't succeed, they fail. So I joined a company which failed. Otherwise, if I had joined the right company, for example, Amazon or Alibaba, I would be a multi-millionaire by now. All right. And I also was an economics lecturer at the Faculty of Economics at the University of Malaya. I started corporate training in 2004, and this is my 17th year providing training services to the private sector as well as the government sector. I have actually taught at Tenaga Research, at TNB Research many years ago, presentation skills. Okay, so my area of specialization is, my areas of specializations are, okay, communication, leadership, English language, which includes writing as well. And I am very happy to be with you. Okay, before we continue with the things that I would like to share with you, I would like to stop sharing my screen. Minta kerjasama tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. Refer to the chat box. Okay. Refer to the chat box. Because I will provide you the test, okay, the pre-test link. Okay. Boleh? Dapat? So, so please do the pre-test. Okay, saya dah beri pautannya. Untuk ujian pretest, please click on the link and do the pretest.
Mana?
Dekat chat box. Tak ada lagi.
Tak ada lah.
Okay, tak ada sekali lagi. Oh, saya hantar
pada. Tak ada chat ni.
Okay, okay. Nah, maaf. Okay.
Okay.
Dapat lah. Okay.
Action tu apa?
Okay, 20 soalan. Jawab. Yeah. Jangan risau, jangan khawatir jika anda tidak tahu kebanyakan jawapan kepada kebanyakan daripada soalannya. Don't worry if you don't know the answer to the majority of the questions, because I haven't started teaching you. Okay. Jadi tidak mengapa. Ya, yeah. Jangan khawatir dan jangan risau. Yang penting esok anda dah tahu jawapan kepada kebanyakan daripada soalannya, ya. Yeah. Okay, so that is more important.
Yes, conclusion.
Yeah.
Ini saya pakai saya punya. Saya dah tak dapat dah link test tu.
Ada dalam chat box. Ada dalam chat box ya. Kalau tak ada saya beri sekali lagi dalam chat box. Entah ya. Disconnected. Ya, yeah, okey. Sebentar. Okey. Korang saya tak ada nama ke? Oh, okey. Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan sekalian, minta maaf ya, borang tu saya ketinggalan ruang untuk anda mengisi nama. Sebentar ya. Saya kena masukkan ruang untuk nama dan minta anda semua mula sekali lagi. Minta maaf ya. Saya baru sedar. Minta maaf saya kena masukkan ruang untuk nama. Entah ya. Okey, sebentar ya. Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, minta maaf. Ada ralat tadi. Saya borang tu saya tak ada bagi yang nama ya. Okey. Sekarang saya bagi ya. Minta maaf ya. Tolong klik link yang baru ni. Minta maaf. Ampun. Minta maaf ya, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry. I forgot to include the space for you to write your name. It is now included, but you need to stop on the old form. Stop answering on the old form and start answering on the new form. Link dia saya dah bagi. Link yang baru tu saya dah bagi dah. Ya, yeah, baru bagi dekat chat link ya. Yeah. Gunakan link yang baru tu. Minta maaf ya. Yeah. Thank you.
what? A report on the distribution of them.
Mak, yang lama mak bagi tu tak nak, tak boleh download kan? Mak tunggu macam mana? Yang lama.
Okey, dah siap dah. Okey, jangan risau, hentam saja. Okey, belum ada lagi peserta yang dah siap. Ah, baru tinggal 3. Okey. Jadi semuanya hari ini ada seramai 28-25 peserta ya. So, ada 5 dah. Saya dah terima daripada siapa ni? Saya dah terima daripada Nira. Bagus. Lo Ching Kim. Okay, thank you. Puan Aisyah. Muhammad apa ni? Muhammad Hanif. Okey. Hanif. Sepuluh. Nur Akma. Nur Kaidir, Muhammad Nur Kaidir. Kim. Ibrahim Halim.
Aisha.
Ya. Yeah. Zazalina. Okay. Hafiz. Faiz. I know Bahia. Okay. Okay, lengkap kan? 25 ya. Okay. Okay, saya sudah terima 18, ada 7 lagi, lengkap kan? Okey, akhir sekali saya terima Ahmad Faizal. Okey, terima kasih. Okey, kita menunggu lagi 3 lagi. Dan 22 saya terima. Okey, thank you Mr. Raghavan. Okay, 23. Keempat. Dan pasti ada seorang lagi ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh para peserta sekalian. Anda sedang menghadiri kursus latihan. Ya, yeah, it is training. Ya. Yeah. Training tak sama dengan webinar. Webinar adalah di mana ada seorang speaker, dia bercakap, ada 200 orang mendengar, semua off camera, semua off microphone. Dia dengar aje macam podcast. Itu adalah webinar. Okay, however, today and tomorrow, we are not having a webinar. We are having a training session. Kita menghadiri kursus latihan. Dan beza latihan dengan webinar adalah kursus dan juga latihan memerlukan keterlibatan anda semua. Anda semua perlu melibatkan diri, perlu buat latihan, perlu on camera dan juga perlu on microphone. Ya, yeah, begitu. Bagus. Terima kasih, Cik Afifi. Bagus. Yang lain ni? Yang mana yang belum bersedia, tolong bersedia. Sediakan diri. Hari ini hari kerja, 9 hingga 5. Perlu bersiapkan diri lah. Okey, terima kasih. Terima kasih. Terima kasih. Okey. Kalau boleh semua on camera, boleh kita ambil gambar pada awal sesi. Okey. Okey, good. Encik Muhammad, Encik Ahmad Faizal, Puan Nira, Puan Aisyah, Kim, Puan Azwadi, switch on your camera so that I can see you. Barulah seronok, ya. Yeah. Kalau tidak nanti apa yang berlaku, kita akan saling bosan membosankan. Betul tak? Saling membosankan tu macam PDPR lah. Apa masalah PDPR kat sekolah? What's the problem with PDPR? Anak-anak kita sekarang menghadapi. Apa masalah dia? Masalah dia, ya, cikgu dia membosankan. Bila cikgu dia membosankan, maka anak-anak kita pun apa dia buat? Off camera. Dia off camera, dia off microphone. Pergi main kucing, pergi serang pokok, pergi main basikal. Lepas tu bila murid-murid tak on camera, bila tak on camera dan tak on microphone, maka cikgu dia pula bosan kerana tak ada respons. Bila cikgu dia bosan, murid-murid lagi bosan, lagi tak nak on camera dan tak nak on microphone. Nah, jadi ada satu kitaran negatif ya, dia in a negative feedback cycle di mana cikgu membosankan murid, murid membosankan cikgu, cikgu membosankan murid dan berterusan ya. Tetapi tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, okey, hari ini dan hari esok janganlah kita bosan membosankan, okey. Jika kita jika kita nak dapat satu manfaat, if you want to get the full benefit of this program, ya, let us not bore each other to death. Let us enjoy our time together, sama-sama menyeronokkan. Saya menyeronokkan anda, saya menggembirakan anda dan anda juga menggembirakan saya. Ha, jadi kita berterusan dalam satu kitaran energi yang positif. Okey? Ha, jadi tak adalah kita jadi bosan aja, lesu aja ya. Alright. Ha, jadi terima kasih kerana anda semua dah on microphone, dah on juga kamera. Okey, saya nak ambil gambar sekarang. Okey, anda boleh posing maut kalau anda nak posing maut. Okey, bersedia? Okey, tak apa. Baru pagi lagi, anda belum pergi kenal saya. Semua masih lagi belum lagi bersedia untuk ceria. Okey, kumpulan ini pula. Skrin satu lagi, bersedia? Okey.
Yeah. Baik.
Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, saya sebenarnya amat teruja untuk bertemu dengan anda semua di permulaan khusus ini. I'm very excited to meet you. Ya, daripada subuh tadi, saya dah bersedia, tak sabar nak berjumpa dengan anda semua, nak bertemu dengan anda semua. Okey? Walau bagaimanapun, saya harap anda juga turut rasa teruja dan ingin bersama dengan saya. Betul ke tidak?
Betul.
Betul. Betul.
Okey. Okey, beginilah ya. Jom kita suntik semangat kita supaya kursus ini tidak membosankan kita. Ya. Jika anda benar-benar teruja, if you are really excited to be with me, jika anda sungguh-sungguh rasa teruja dan jika anda rasa anda mahu bersama dengan saya, apabila saya bilang 1, 2, 3, saya minta anda semua serentak untuk on mikrofon dan menjerit yeay! Yeay! 6 harakat. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Okay, on microphone, bersedia. Satu, dua, tiga.
Okay, bagus.
Jadi kita kekalkan semangat kita. Ya, sungguh-sungguh kita rasa teruja dalam kursus ini. InsyaAllah kita tidak rasa masa berlalu dengan begitu perlahan sekali jika kita rasa teruja. Ya. So please allow me to share my screen, ladies and gentlemen. Jadi jangan risau kerana kursus ini saya akan kendalikan dalam dua bahasa, bahasa Inggeris dan juga bahasa Melayu. Dan jangan risau jika anda tak faham kerana anda juga dibenarkan untuk bertanya dan saya bersedia untuk menjawab soalan-soalan anda. Okey, jadi soalan dalam ujian pretest tadi itu adalah preview kepada perkara-perkara yang akan saya ajar sepanjang kursus ini. So that was a preview. So I will be teaching you the answers to the questions that you have answered just now. Jadi belum boleh jawab. Ramai yang tak boleh jawab lagi kebanyakan persoalan kerana saya belum lagi mula mengajar. Jangan risau, saya akan mengajar anda supaya anda boleh menjawab kebanyakan daripada soalannya. Ya. Yeah? Okey, baik tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. Saya ada menyediakan landasan syllabus untuk kursus ini. Ya. Yeah? Walau bagaimanapun, ya, yeah, jangan risau. Kerana apa yang anda nak belajar sebenarnya lebih penting, jauh lebih penting daripada apa yang saya nak ajar. So what you want to learn from me, ladies and gentlemen, is far more important than what I want to teach you, okay? So what you want to learn from me is far more important than what I want to teach you. Okay, jadikan kursus ini milik anda. Ya, dengan cara banyak bertanya, dengan cara banyak berinteraksi dengan saya, jadikan milik anda. Kalau anda tidak berinteraksi dengan saya, if you don't interact with me, you don't communicate with me, malangnya kursus ini akan jadi milik saya. Saya tidak mahu kursus ini menjadi milik saya kerana saya khawatir apa yang akan saya ajar nanti tidak relevan kepada suasana kerja anda. Tidak relevan kepada laporan teknikal yang anda sediakan. Ya, dan saya tidak mahu kita sia-siakan 2 hari kita bersama. Jadi perlulah kita sama-sama berusaha bekerjasama untuk menjadikan kursus ini milik anda. So please help me to customize the program and the syllabus to meet your requirement and your needs. Okay? Ha, jadi jadikan milik anda, jangan jadikan kursus ini milik saya. Baik, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. There are 2 ways of delivering this program. Ada 2 cara untuk saya kendalikan kursus ini. Ada 2 cara. Cara pertama is for me to deliver this program in a very serious manner. Seriously serious. Yeah? Kalau serious ni, anda tidak dibenarkan untuk makan dan minum dalam kelas saya. You are not allowed to ask questions. You are not allowed to ask for clarification. You are not allowed to share your opinion, share your experience. You are not allowed to laugh. You are not allowed to laugh at me. Dan yang paling penting sekali, anda juga tidak dibenarkan sama sekali untuk pergi ke bilik air. No, Mr. Raghavan, you are not allowed to go to the toilet if I select the seriously serious mode. Okay. Cara kedua adalah untuk saya kendalikan kursus ini in a fun and exciting manner in order to bring about the encouraging learning environment for you to continue learning. Dalam jika kita memilih fun, maka anda dibenarkan makan dan minum sambil saya mengajar. You are allowed to ask questions, share your opinion, share your experience, ask for clarification. You are allowed to laugh. You are also allowed to laugh at me. Anda dibenarkan untuk ketawakan saya juga. Yang mana pilihan anda? Serious? Ceria? Which one?
Ceria.
Okay, kalau nak ceria, kalau anda benar-benar sungguh-sungguh nak ceria, kalau Nurul Dasani, Puan Nurul Dasani benar-benar nak ceria, jom, apabila saya bilang 1, 2, 3, sama-sama serendak kata nak ceria. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Boleh. Boleh. Okey, 1, 2, 3.
Nak ceria. Nak ceria. Nak
ceria. Kita buat gila-gila 2 hari ni supaya ceria, okey? Walau bagaimanapun, tuan-tuan dan puan, nak ceria. Saya seorang diri tak mampu dan tak boleh, tak dapat untuk membangkitkan suasana keceriaan yang anda mahu. Kerana kalau nak ceria, perlu kerjasama tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. I need your cooperation to bring about the fun learning environment that you desire. There are 3 things that I need from you. Pertama, response. Okay? So if you want this to be fun learning environment, you need to be very responsive. Very responsive. Contohnya, apabila saya bertanyakan soalan, saya minta anda semua untuk berebut-rebut menjawab soalan macam budak tahun 1, tahun 2 di sekolah. Macam mana Encik Raghavan? Budak tahun 1, tahun 2 di sekolah bila cikgu tanya soalan, Mr. Raghavan?
Semua angkat tangan.
Semua angkat tangan. Lagi macam mana?
Saya cikgu.
Betul. Saya. Saya lah.
Saya.
Saya tahu jawapan dia. Kenapa Cikgu Asyik panggil Nurul aja? Cikgu suka Nurul ya? Okey, angkat tangan. Tentu ya. Okey, jadi berebut-rebut. In English, is called competitively answering questions. Jadi, saya harap bila saya bertanya, berebut-rebutlah kita bertanya, menjawab soalan ya. Malangnya tahun 1, tahun 2 berebut. Tahun 3 kurang. Tahun 4 kurang. Tahun 5 UPSR masuk tingkatan 3, tingkatan 5 masuk universiti. Mula kerja TNBR, langsung tidak ada respons lagi. Bila bos bagi taklimat dalam meeting room, lepas tu bos tanya, ada apa-apa pandangan? Any suggestion? Semua diam aja. Semua diam aja. Kenapa semua diam, Aino? Bila bos tanya, ada pandangan ke tidak? Kenapa semua diam?
Entahlah.
Tak tahu. Aino diam ke menjawab kalau bos tanya? Ada apa-apa cadangan? Any suggestion? Macam mana? Aino jawab ke atau diam?
Tengok mood hari tu kot.
Tengok mood pula? Ada mood?
Perempuan mesti ada mood.
Ada mood? Faiz macam mana? Faiz jawab ke tidak Faiz?
Saya biasa point Aino jawab kan?
Point Aino jawab kan? Rahim macam mana Rahim? Jawab ke tak?
Ada bos dalam ni, tak ada cakap.
Ada bos dalam ni. Ada bos dalam ni. Okay, selalunya lah. Saya dah kerja dekat Maxis, dah kerja dekat Shell, dah kerja dekat UM. Mana-mana saya dah kerja dah. Selalunya the normal behavior is not to be responsive. Bila bos tanya, do you have any suggestion? Do you have anything to add? Do you have any question? Semua diam aja pandang ke bawah kan. Ada orang kata, Cik Azmi, sebenarnya kita tak ada apa-apa pandangan. Sebenarnya tak benar juga. Kerana dalam mesyuarat, bos tanya, ada pandangan, semua diam. Tapi selepas mesyuarat, pergi ke pantry. Kalau saya lah. Ataupun pergi ke bawah tangga. If I were the boss. Jadi kalau mula ayat, if I were the boss, kalau saya boss, maksudnya ada pandangan. Cuma pandangan dalam mesyuarat tak nak bagi. Dekat bilik pantry, dekat bawah tangga, nak bagi. Ingat? Kenapa? Why this behavior? Sebab sebenarnya kita semua tidak mahu diberi tanggungjawab. Tidak mahu diberi tanggungjawab tambahan. Katakanlah, ya, kalau saya dalam mesyuarat saya kata, okay, kita ada masalah, kita ada masalah lah dalam dalam pejabat kita ni. Semua staff kita ni macam tak bersemangat, lesu. Tak ada semangat kekawanan, kekitaan. Ya, no teamship, no team. Okay, no team spirit. Ada siapa-siapa nak bagi cadangan macam mana kita boleh pulihkan semangat camaraderie kita, team spirit kita? Ada siapa-siapa nak bagi cadangan? Ada siapa-siapa nak bagi cadangan? Bagilah cadangan.
Masukkan dalam KPI.
Masukkan dalam KPI? Masukkan dalam KPI apa? Untuk senyum bila dalam pejabat?
Buat apa makan-makan
dia? Oh, siapa cakap tadi?
Saya.
Siapa bagi cadangan ni? Encik Afifi, bagus. Terima kasih Encik Afifi. Okey, Encik Afifi, sila laksanakan. Itu sebenarnya yang kita mengelak. Sebab bila kita bagi cadangan, bos akan tunjuk kita, sila laksanakan. Betul tak?
Ya, betul. Jadi betul kan?
Sangat betul. Sangat betul.
Kita tak nak bagi cadangan sebab kita takut diberi tanggungjawab. Kalau kita diberi tanggungjawab, maka kita kena stay back. Balik pukul 7 malam. Dapatkan sebut harga. Sediakan venue dan sebagainya. Kita tak mau. So that is negative, okay? So please be positive, be responsive to your bosses. Jadi mula daripada kursus ini, hari ini, apabila saya bertanyakan soalan, tolonglah. Be responsive and respond, okay? Dan harapannya supaya anda selepas kursus ini terbawa-bawa sikap baru ini dan anda terus responsif kepada bos anda. Okey? Ini budaya kerja yang baru kita. Bukan hanya apabila saya bertanya soalan anda perlu responsif. Ya, anda juga perlu apabila saya minta anda melakukan apa-apa aktiviti, buatlah dengan sungguh-sungguh. Contohnya, bila saya minta berlatih menulis, buatlah sungguh-sungguh. Okey? Bila saya minta anda pergi ke breakout room, pergilah ke breakout room sungguh-sungguh. Bila saya minta anda tepuk tangan, tepuklah tangan. Okey, tepuk. Okey, bagus. Right. So that's responsive. Number two, please ask lots and lots of questions. Kalau ada soalan, terus saja on microphone dan bertanya. Kalau ada soalan, terus on microphone, tanya. Jangan tunggu sehingga rehat. Jangan tunggu selepas habis kursus. Jangan tunggu lepas hari raya Aidiladha baru nak telefon saya nak tanya. Hello Cik Azmi. Hari tu Cik Azmi mengajar kita di TNB ada soalan saya nak tanya. Hari tu tak tanya. Okay, nak tanya, tanya sekarang. If you have a question, please ask immediately. Don't keep to yourself. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Dan yang terakhir sekali ya, Encik Afifi dan Faik dan kawan-kawan kita yang lain, yang akhir sekali, laughter. Jadi dalam kursus ini, dari masa ke semasa, saya akan menyelitkan unsur-unsur jenaka. Apabila anda mendengar saya cuba berjenaka, tolonglah ketawa. Kata tadi, you want a fun and learning environment, so please laugh. Ya, biarlah mudah saya menghibur anda kerana saya memang cuba untuk menghibur anda. Senanglah ketawa. Jangan susah sangat ketawa. Ya, janganlah pula peluk tubuh dia kata apa pun trainer kata hari ini saya langsung tak nak ketawa. Okey, janganlah macam tu ya. Okey, saya tahu saya taklah pandai sangat kadang-kadang jenaka saya ke laut. You can still laugh at me. You can laugh at my poor attempt at telling a joke. Boleh juga, ya. Yang pasti tuan-tuan dan puan, I will be looking out for opportunities to laugh at you. Saya akan mencari peluang-peluang untuk ketawakan anda. Jadi sebelum anda diketawakan, ketawakanlah saya. Tak ketawa pun? Tak ketawa pun? Ada punchline tadi tu.
Belum lagi kot.
Janganlah. Susah sangat nak ketawa. Okay. Okay, I'm trying to entertain you. Okay, jadi topik kita dua hari ini, technical report writing. Kerana anda semua adalah ya pakar ataupun penyelidik. You are all researchers. Jadi bila kita buat research, kita perlu menulis laporan. Kalau tidak, bos tak tahu apalah Nur Kaidi buat dekat bilik dia, apalah dia buat dekat apa tu dekat meja dia kan. Jadi laporan itu bukti anda ada buat kerja. Ya, tapi janganlah menulis laporan sekadar menulis laporan. Don't write a report for the sake of writing a report. Please write a useful report. Okey, banyak orang buat kerja macam itulah. Ya, menulis laporan tapi bila orang lain baca tak apa-apa laporan dia. Okey, so you are writing for the sake of writing a report. Oh, KPI saya kena buat 12 laporan. Okey, one report per month. Okey, no. Okay, from now onwards, we are going to change your mindset. Okay, so that you write proper and useful reports. Useful reports. So, macam mana nak tahu useful ke tak? Bila orang lain baca, dia pun faham. Bila orang lain baca, ya, ikut step-step awak, dia pun boleh ulang balik ujian dan eksperimen anda. Itu yang kita katakan sebagai a useful report. Kalau orang baca, apalah Ibrahim tulis ni? Jomlah kita cuba buat. Sampai langkah kedua, step tu. Eh, dia ni ada skip ke langkah dia ni? Macam mana daripada langkah ke sini pergi ke langkah tiga ni? Ada missing step ni. Ada secret ingredient ni. Kan? Jadi that is not useful. Yeah? So let me give you the proper definition of what a technical report is. Kena faham dulu. Eh? Okay. Jadi methodology kita beginilah. Eh? Saya akan cakap sikit-sikit. I will give you some theory and then I will break you into your breakout rooms. Anda akan menulis. Kemudiannya saya akan kumpul bahan yang anda telah tulis dan saya akan perbetulkan. I will correct your mistakes. Okay? And your written output in this program will be in English. Tapi saya akan mengajar bercampur-campur bahasa Inggeris dan bahasa Melayu supaya suasana lebih ceria. Okey, dan anda faham. Tetapi latihannya perlulah dalam bahasa Inggeris. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Okey, jadi kalau kita kata kita nak menulis laporan teknikal. Jadi kita kena faham, you must understand first, what is the meaning of technical? Technical skills tu apa? Okay, jadi by definition, yeah, technical skills is the ability and the knowledge that you use to do something. Okay, like driving a car. So driving a car requires technical knowledge. Bukan knowledge about internal combustion engine. Itu tak perlu. Tetapi technical knowledge, for example, start the car engine. Okay, release the brake, release the handbrake, engage the gear, press the accelerator pedal. Okay, jadi itu adalah technical knowledge untuk yang anda perlu untuk mengendalikan kereta. Jadi jika saya minta anda menulis satu laporan atau menulis arahan, instruction ya, kepada orang lain untuk memandu kereta, jadi kena tulis dengan cara yang mudah supaya dia faham. Kalau dia tak mudah arah kita, dia tak faham. Dia kena understand ya. Dia kena drive a car. So must be precise and easy to understand. And then number two, it must be complete. So the steps must be complete so that someone reading your instruction can follow your instruction and drive a car. Kalau dia kena, hello, Nurul, Puan Nurul, saya baca arahan Puan Nurul ni, cara-cara macam mana nak memandu kereta. Saya dah langkah nombor 2 ni, tak faham lah. Langkah nombor 3 ni, macam mana eh? Pedal ni, pedal yang mana satu eh? Kat kaki ni ada 3 pedal ni, mana satu eh Puan Nurul? Ha, kan? Maksudnya, arahan Puan Nurul lengkap ke tidak?
Tak.
Ah, tak lengkap. Sebab dia tak boleh follow. Dia tak boleh ikut. Okay? Alright, so apa sajalah yang berkaitan dengan alat mekanikal ke yang menggunakan teknologi dan sebagainya, itu adalah dikira sebagai technical. Okay. The definition of technical writing pula. Ha, jadi ini definition dia. So technical writing is a type of writing where you write about a subject by giving instruction or explanation. So, saya kata tadilah, how to drive a car, how to operate a forklift, how to conduct an experiment, how to do this test, how to use this instrument. Jadi benda-benda semua itu adalah berkaitan dengan technical, dan jika anda menulis arahan-arahan itu, then it becomes technical writing. Belum report, baru technical writing. So technical writing is all about transferring the skills of doing something onto paper. Okay, so that's what writing is all about, yeah. So you transfer your knowledge of doing something to paper. So that's what technical writing is all about. Then what is the purpose of technical writing? So the purpose of technical writing is so that people reading what you have written can understand 100% and follow your instruction to either operate an equipment or a machinery, or in your case, to duplicate the experiment that you have done. Itu sebenarnya. Jadi maksudnya, kita bila kita menulis laporan teknikal, kita bukan menulis cara bagaimana arahan nak memandu kereta atau memandu forklift, bukan. Ya, ya, sebab kita semua adalah penyelidik. Jadi untuk penyelidik pula, ya, bila kita menulis laporan, bukan hanya sekadar melaporkan keputusan. No. Ya, bukan melaporkan keputusan eksperimen anda, bukan. Tetapi anda perlu melaporkan juga langkah-langkah dan juga peralatan yang anda guna semasa anda membuat eksperimen itu, supaya orang lain yang membaca laporan itu, dia boleh ulang balik eksperimen yang anda telah lakukan dan mendapat keputusan yang sama. Itu gunanya. Itu gunanya laporan kita. Supaya satu, dapat keputusan. Okey. Tapi kalau nak cuba jugalah macam mana Puan Aina buat ni. Okey, kita cuba. Okey, ikut langkah dia. Oh, pertama kita ambil equipment A. Yang kedua kita ambil bahan B. Yang ketiga C. Nah, seterusnya kita ikut langkah-langkah yang dilaporkan oleh Encik Ain, oleh Cik Ainul. Kemudiannya kita boleh ikut successful experiment dan dapat keputusan yang sama. Kalau buat benda yang sama dapat keputusan lain pun salah juga. Okay, jadi mesti duplicable, replicable. Maksudnya boleh diulang. Siapa-siapa yang mendapat laporan kita senaskah, dia boleh ulang balik eksperimen kita dan mendapat keputusan yang sama. Itu yang kita panggil sebagai technical report writing. Apa yang kita laporkan? Lapor keputusan. Apa lagi kita laporkan? Laporkan langkah-langkah. Itu sebenarnya. Okay? Right? Jadi kalau saya tanya Encik Afifi, laporan ni guna untuk apa Afifi? What is the purpose of you writing a technical report? KPI? Tak. Apa dia Encik Afifi?
Supaya orang akan datang boleh follow balik lah.
Ah, orang yang kemudian lah. Kan? Orang yang kemudian kan? Ah, dia boleh ikut balik, follow. Dan dapat keputusan yang sama. Maksud confirm. Kan? Ah, kita dapat finding A, dia ulang balik pun dapat finding A. Ah, confirm betul lah tu. Kan? Ah, kalau tak tu ada something missing or something is wrong. Bila dia ikut set-set kita, tapi dapat keputusan lain kan? Ah, jadi kalau scientific selalunya dapat keputusan yang samalah. Sebab namanya scientific and objective. Kalau subjektif ikut perasaan memanglah. Hari ikut mood pula kan. Jadi scientific ni tak ada ikut mood. Okay. Voltan dan juga Ampere tak ikut mood. Dia tak ada ikut mood hari ni lah. Tengok voltan berapa. Tak ada. Okay. Jadi semuanya objektif and scientific. Bila scientific, dia tak ada rahsia dan tak ada magic. Maksudnya it is duplicable and replicable. Jadi apa purpose kita dua hari ni? Purpose dua hari kita ni adalah untuk kita belajar cara menulis dalam bahasa Inggeris supaya jelas keputusan yang kita dapat. Kemudiannya jelas juga langkah-langkah yang kita telah ambil semasa kita melakukan eksperimen itu. Langkah-langkah kita ambil termasuk juga cara kita mengumpul maklumat, mengumpul data dan sebagainya, dan cara kita membuat analisanya pun kita laporkan juga, dan akhir sekali kita laporkan keputusannya, hasilnya ya. So that is a complete technical report, a very good report. Tapi malangnya kalau kita short sendiri ni, maksudnya kita menulis laporan for the sake of writing a report. Okay, you are writing a report for the sake of writing a report. Kalau kita tanya, contohnya kita tanya Faik. Faik, why did you write this report, Faik? Lepas tu Faik kata, because this is my KPI, Encik Azmi. I have to write. Faik, berapa laporan kau kena tulis satu tahun, Faik? Berapa laporan, Faik? How many? On your microphone, Faik. Janganlah malu. How many reports do you need to produce in a year? What's your KPI for research output?
Based on project kita lah.
How many projects?
If currently we have 2 or 3 projects.
Hmm?
So every project you need to produce progress report, right? So
progress.
Around 2 atau 3 lah kot.
2 atau 3. In a year, ya?
Yeah.
Okay, betul. Tadi kata progress report. Jadi, dalam soalan saya pun ada pasal progress report, ya? Yeah? So, progress report can also be a technical report, ya? Yeah?
Okay, Azmi, nak kata.
Ya, yeah, saya?
Sorry, saya nak tanya. Nak tanya sikit.
Ya.
Yeah. By right, one of the question yang saya nak tanya tu, betul lah tadi, is progress report a technical report? So jawapannya ialah kan?
Encik Faik jawab tadi. Bukan saya jawab, Encik Faik jawab.
Okay. Secondly, sebab ialah kita baru mula, so I just nak faham the whole training ni towards the end petang nanti sampai esok semua kan? Okay, so when we are talking about technical writing, so it refers to yang full report dalam Word punya version, or this one also implies to yang PowerPoint ataupun dalam bentuk slide punya
form. Okay, it's the Microsoft Word. Up to the Microsoft Word, it does not include the presentation of the technical report. Okay?
Oh, okay. So, kita punya training, dia punya
writing
dekat situ lah.
It's only writing. It does not include the apa tu, the presentation of the technical report. Okay? Several years ago, I conducted a program at TNBR. Okay? And it was the the technical presentation. Jadi, masa tu saya tak mengajar writing. So, it was the presenting of the technical report. So, I assume je lah, semua assume. Okay, semua dah ada lah report. Okay. So, report the findings and report the method that you use for your experiment kan? Itu je. Okay, so okay. So kita boundary kita is just writing aja ya?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, very good. Good question. Okay, so that is clarified. So, it's all about writing only. Yeah. Okay, so betul lah Faik kata tadi. So progress report is also technical report because you are reporting. Okay, kita kata pada awal project, we will be conducting 4 tests. Yeah, we will conduct 4 tests to prove this or prove that. Yeah, and then sampai bulan Jun, kita laporkan we have conducted 2 tests. The result of the 2 tests are, so progress ni. Tapi kita masih laporkan what test did we do? How did we conduct the experiment? Right? So therefore, it is a progress report as well as a technical report. Alright? So that answers the earlier question that I gave you in the apa tu in the pretest, yeah.
That's me.
Yes, saya.
Progress report, the focus is more towards the result and not on the methodology itself. So how can that be considered as a technical report?
Okay. For example, yeah. So in the apa tu, when you started the project, okay, the brief given to you, okay, that for example, yeah. You need to test a particular equipment or a particular material, the suitability of a particular material, and you gave a timeline. You need, for example, 8 months, and during the 8 month period, you will conduct 4 types of tests. Contohnya, 1 destructive test, 1 another non-destructive test, satu lagi mungkin chemical test ke, whatever test lah. Okay. So, halfway mark, normally you will be asked to present an interim report or what we call a progress report. So, you have conducted only 2 tests, destructive and non-destructive, right? So, you report on these 2. So, first, you report on the non-destructive. Okay, so what was the methodology you used? What was the equipment you used? How did you test? What was the experiment? Okay, and what was the result? So therefore, it is a technical report. Okay, it's not the complete technical report that you have promised using the 4 types of tests, but it is still a technical report because you are reporting on the use of technology to conduct these 2 tests, and you are also reporting the findings from the 2 tests. Okay, Cik Azwadi.
Okay.
Okay, unless at TNBR you do it differently for your progress report. Unless at TNBR, okay, you don't give a full-fledged progress report at the halfway mark. You only report the findings only, without deliberating and reporting your methodology and the experiments that you have conducted. So in some organizations, yeah, at the halfway mark or quarter mark, right, they don't require the full report. So just the findings only. Tu. So mungkinlah that one less technical because you're just reporting the findings only and you wait until the end to give the full report, which includes the experiments and the technologies that you have used, the methodology for the four types of tests. Okay, so I guess maybe the confusion here is because the culture at the TMBR, maybe at halfway mark, you don't give a full half report. Okay, so it's just the report, very brief report finding only. Yeah, just the findings at the halfway mark, that's all. Okay? If I answer your question, Encik Azwadi?
Yeah, okay, yes.
Okay. I'm sure many of you are also academic researchers. Ada tak academic researchers kat sini? PhD? Ada tak? Aisyah? No?
Ada.
Ada kan? Okay. So the difference between...
InsyaAllah.
InsyaAllah. Okay. I pray that you will get your PhD as well. Okay, your doctorate. Okay, your doctoral degree. Now, the difference between a technical report and an academic thesis is the literature review. The literature review. Actually, the difference is that chapter. It's on literature review because for academic writing, you require to also produce literature review. Okay, and you write down your sources, apa semua. Eh? However, for a technical report, you don't need to do literature review, extensive literature review, and to include a paragraph or a few pages of literature review. No, it's not required. Okay?
So, Cik Azmi, can we summary it as technical report ni macam dia report whatever result yang you have based on whatever things yang you do. Tak kisahlah berjaya ke tak berjaya, kan?
Ya, berjaya ke tak berjaya. Okay. Berjaya ke tak berjaya, you report lah, kan? Okay. So, there are a few categories. Nanti I will share you my notes. Eh? Then you see exactly what I mean in my notes. Yeah. In fact, I will do it now. Okay, so let me share in my chat. Let me give you my notes. I'm looking for my notes sekarang ni. OneDrive, okay. Ini dia bawah. Presentation. Okay, so I have started sharing my note. So you can get the notes that I've shared with you in the chat box. You can download it there. In fact, I've given you two documents. Okay, jadi kalau kita tengok dekat screen saya ni, yeah. The primary purpose of technical writing. Yeah. So the first one there, I've written there. Explains how a particular object works or how to complete a task or project. So in this, in your case, if it is a report, to explain how you conducted the experiment. Okay. To explain how you have conducted the experiment. So that someone reading the report can duplicate the experiment. So that's the test. So the test, whether it is effective or not, your report, yeah, is whether someone who has picked up the report can duplicate your experiment or not. Jadi scientific objectivity means all experiments are duplicable and all results are duplicable. Otherwise, is not, you don't have scientific objectivity. Okay? So make sure that you have this. Someone reading your report can duplicate your experiment. It's not just reporting the result. Okay. So now I want to stop sharing this screen because I want to share another screen. Where is my... Okay. Okay, so if you can look at the, if you look at my, the notes that I've given you, it's the same one I'm showing you now. Okay. All right. So if you look at this, yeah, in the introduction, okay, in the introduction of the report, you need to state the reasons, i.e. the objective of embarking on the particular project, right? It can be one of the following. So the objectives can be one of the following. First, to solve a problem. For example, how to reduce pollution. Okay, how to reduce noise pollution. Okay, how to reduce loss of energy during transmission. Contohnya lah. Okay, so that is solving a problem. So the objective is to solve a problem. The second objective can be, so I kata can be because I don't know, yeah. Can be a report to compare the performance of equipment A or equipment B. So your boss may tell you, oh, kita nak belilah dua alat ni. Tolong check. Do a test. Which one is better, A or B? Which cable is better, cable A or cable B? Which lubricant, which transmission transformer oil is better? Shell or Petronas? Bagi. So you need to check. I just recall when I was at Shell, I sold lots and lots of transformer oil to TNB. Okay, okay. So the most important thing in the transformer oil is water content or humidity. So that one I remember from 20 years ago. Okay, so check lubricants, transformer oil A, transformer oil B. Check the performance of equipment A, equipment B, material A, material B. So you have to conduct your test. So this can be another reason for embarking on the project. So the third reason for the project could be to replicate an experiment reported in the publication. So mungkin your boss baca-baca, dia kata macam ni lah, guna this material or this equipment, the transmission rate increase. Please duplicate. Kan? Tengok, betul lah. Can you duplicate the same thing? Can we get the same result? So you have to go and experiment. So you have to follow the steps given by that report. Okay? So replicate an experiment. Lepas tu satu lagi, verify a claim. So maybe a manufacturer or maybe an OEM, right? When they were promoting a particular product, material or equipment to you, contohnya gas probe, dia boleh claim, oh, this one can detect oxygen ke whatever gas ke at 5 parts per million. Betul ke? Test. And then you produce a report. Kan? So that can be another reason for you to come up with a report. Okay. Lepas tu I kata lagi, or any other reason that require scientific test or experiment. Yeah. Or any other reason to require, that require scientific test or experiment. Okay. Other than this, ada yang selain daripada apa yang saya beri sini, is there any other reason that you embark on a technical project? Ada tak? Ada tak? Other than this, selain daripada ni, ada tak? Ada tak, Hafiz? Selain daripada ni? Tengok projek yang you buat ni. Actually, I should have signed an NDA with the NBR, kan? Jadi, you are so that you can freely share with me, kan? Tapi masalah, I didn't sign an NDA. I kita lupa nak sign NDA, nak minta NDA, kan? Anyway, if you look at your current project, under which category does your current project fall under, Cik Hafiz?
Yang ni lah. Yang Cik Azmi nyatakan ni lah. Banyakannya yang ni lah, to solve problem, to compare performance.
Ya, yeah, tapi the current one that you are doing now?
Sekarang ni to verify a claim, a failure claim by a manufacturer.
Verify a failure claim?
Okay. Failure reason lah, reason.
Okay, so it falls under verify a claim lah, kan? Okay, betul juga, ada juga. Encik Azwadi?
I'm looking into what do you call that? Verify the method.
Verify the method. Okay. Verify the method. Yang itu mungkin replicate experiment lah. I think so, yeah. Verify the method. Orang lain pakai method tu, kita cuba verify. That means you have to replicate the experiment, kan? Yeah, reported elsewhere in other publications, yeah. So it will fall under one of these, or the last one, other reasons that require scientific test or experiment. Okay. So if we understand that that's what we are trying to do, then it's easier now, yeah. Okay, so after that, bila kita dah when we are clear of the objective, right? So in the body, all you need to do is this. See, provide clear details of the scientific test and experiment, explain or state the scientific theory or the methodology behind your experiment, and share the design of the experiment. Okay, the rigging that you set up, semua benda tu. Okay, and then you can also talk about the problems encountered. And then the data collection and the analysis. And also talk about the limitations and the parameters of your test. So it doesn't work for temperature above 200 degrees. Contohnya lah. It only works below 200 degrees. So that's the parameters of the test. The limitations, yeah. Okay. And then the conclusion. Balik ke sini, ya. Conclusion balik kepada the reasons for embarking in the project. Okay, so kalau kita earlier tadi kita kata to solve a problem, how to reduce pollution. So in the conclusion, so you need to tell us whether you have discovered a technique to reduce pollution or not. Ha, kan? Kalau tak ada, tak adalah. Kalau ada, you still have to report. Or if the objective was to compare the performance, equipment A versus equipment B, so the conclusion is, which equipment perform better? If you were to replicate a methodology, a method, then you replicate, and then you have to report. Did you manage to replicate the experiment and achieve the reported result? Did you manage to replicate the method and achieve the reported result? Nah, itu Encik Azwadi tadi lah. Okay, kalau Encik Hafiz, to verify a claim. So could you verify the, ni the sensitivity lah, ni like, we're talking about sensitivity of gas probe, kan? So could you verify the sensitivity as claimed by the manufacturer? So it's all very very apa tu, very logical, very logical, yeah. It's only three steps, and only three big chapters. Bukan five macam thesis five, okay? So it's only three, yeah. So the introduction, and then the body, and the conclusion. That's all. Okay. Any question? No question. Okay, so we are going to start practice writing. Okay. Okay, kita practice writing dulu. Now, for this exercise, it's a simple one. I just want you to, I will give you a problem. So I will break you into five groups. So when you break into respective groups, discuss the problem, and someone please write. I want you to write a proper report, tapi not the full one. I only want you to write in the report, yeah. I only want you to report the experiment that you have conducted. Ini kena have conducted tu maksudnya kita berlakon, kita dah buat lah. Actually, you just discuss only. Okay? And then, yeah. So, report the experiment that you have conducted to achieve the objective which I will tell you. Okay, so let me now tell you what the objective is. Okay, I'm the management. Okay, so we are considering to purchase two brands of ballpoint. Two brands of ballpoint, brand A and brand B. Okay, please report to us which brand lasts longer. Which brand lasts longer? Ada dua jenama, pen A dan pen B. Okay, jadi tulis dalam satu laporan ringkas, body dia je, introduction tak payah, conclusion pun tak payah, just the body je. I only want you to report on the experiment that you conduct to test pen mana, jenama mana yang boleh tahan lagi lama. Tahan tu maksudnya, so let me define tahan. Tahan tu maksudnya dakwat dia lagi banyak. Dakwat dia kita boleh menggunakan lagi lama lah, ada dakwat. Tolak tepi mechanical failure of the ball bearing. Okay, the roller ball. Tolak tepi mechanical failure. So tell us, report to us what experiment, what equipment, what methodology, what steps you want to take to conduct this experiment and achieve a result, either A or B. Okay, faham tak?
Tuan, boleh ulang, you said about what experiment, what tool is it?
Okay, I'm the management. So we are considering and deliberating to buy either pen A or pen B, brand A, brand B. Okay, ballpoint. Okay, both ballpoint. Okay, so now before we buy, we would like you to tell us which ballpoint brand will last longer. Will last longer tu maksudnya will write longer, lagi banyak dakwat lah. Tolak tepi mechanical failure of the ball, of the ballpoint, eh. Pasal pakai roller, pakai bearing kan. Nah, tolak tepi the mechanical failure. It's just the ink. Boleh. Okay, there's no one answer. There banyak cara. So whatever test you want to do, you just discuss in your group and then you write. Okay, you write what experiment, laporkan. Yeah, report the experiment that you have conducted? Kenapa have? Sebab kita tak masuk amal kan? Okay, so tell us lah what equipment you use, what methodology you use, what kind of test you use, how you collected your data. Right? Okay, boleh tak? Boleh kan? All of you are scientists. Mestilah boleh. I'm not a scientist. I'm an economist. Okay? My master's degree is in economics. Okay, but I'm not a scientist. But I give you this. I give you this this problem for you to solve scientifically. Okay. Boleh, eh? So I'm going to break you into 5 rooms. And you can continue discussing in your group until 10:45. We are going to have our coffee break at 10:45, 1.5 hours. After that, you can continue some more. By 11:30, yeah, please send me the report because I will start correcting your grammar and your sentence.
Okay. Just now you said you're sharing a report in the chat. I didn't see anything there.
Share report? Bukan report. My notes. I've given the notes.
Notes. Dekat chat. I didn't see anything.
Dua. You didn't see anything? I shared with everybody. So if you have not received it, then I will send it again shortly. Okay?
Thanks.
Okay, I'll send it shortly. Don't worry. Okay. So I send you the notes. Okay, I've also sent you NASA technical report. Jadi kita tengok orang NASA tulis technical report diorang macam mana. Macam-macam. Ada 60 projects that they are report, they've reported in that report that I have shared with you. Macam-macam lah. Sensor lah, roket lah, apa je projek diorang. Okay, so we can look at that later. Right? So just do the task that I've asked you to do now. Boleh ke tidak?
Boleh.
Boleh, ya? Okay, so I'm going to break you into 5 rooms. 5 rooms. Okay, so get a leader to lead you in each group. Kedak tu nanti, nothing gets done if there's no leader. Okay? So are you ready?
Yes!
Ready. Yeah, come on! Be excited! Be interesting! Ah, bukan selalu ni kita nak eksperimen, nak test pen ballpoint kan? Okay, so when I count 1, 2, 3, minta semua jerit, I am ready! 1, 2, 3!
I am ready!
Okay. So I will create the rooms and I've opened the rooms. About 6 to 7 in each room, okay? So I will see you later. I will join you in your rooms and visit you, okay? Bye, Nurul, bye. Okay, bye, Ainul, bye, Masita. Okay, bye. I will see you in your rooms. Okay, bye, Nurul. Hafiz, bye, Hafiz. Hello guys. Hey.
Hello.
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 Okay. Macam mana ni? Jenama A ke jenama B? Scientific objectivity. So what's your experiment? Turn on your face. Switch on your camera. Yeah. Okay, bagus Hafiz. Yeah. Mr. Low. Okay, good. Kalau in reality, you may be given equipment A or equipment B, eh? Or material A, material B, but I've just simplified it to ballpoint A and ballpoint B brand.
Tulis 100 pages lah.
Tak tahu lah, I don't know. Kalau if that's your method, you write the report. Kata in your report, you say the methodology of the experiment is to write 100 pages or to write as many pages. Tapi kena write pages tu straight line ke, apa jarak-jarak dia ke, satu page ada berapa line you nak buat tu. Baru kita tahu benda tu objektif. Nak kira berapa pages. Kan? Up to you. You are scientist. So if you are given this task, what kind of experiment do you want to design to test? Which one can write longer? Nak timbang air ke? Nak timbang ke? I don't
know. You can identify the volume of ink. Tak perlu buat
air. It's up to you. It's up to you. You can ada je kata nak timbang air ke, nak timbang ke. Okay, it's up to you. Nak tulis ke? Nak ukur panjang tulisan ke? Itu yang kata tolak tepi mechanical failure lah. Kan? Because I believe today, most pen fail bukan sebab tak ada ink, but most pens fail because of mechanical failure. Betul tak, Dr. Azwadi?
For me, the failure because of loss of pen.
Loss of pen. Baru pakai sikit dah hilang ke? Mungkin juga lah. Failure, loss of pen. Itu memory failure. Okay, tapi tolak tepi memory failure. I think before the ink run out, we either lose the pen or mechanical failure. The ball bearing yang fail. Kan? So tak tepi tu, it's just the ink. How do you apa tu conduct an experiment that will prove which brand's ink will last longer, will write a lot more words. Macam tu lah. Okay, I'll come and join you guys later. Yeah. Okay, this is fun. Seronok ni. Okay. Apa progress group ni?
Baru lantik jawatan kuasa.
Baru lantik chairman.
Ya Allah, ini susah ni bila apa tu kita gunakan komiti
Tak
manage experiment by committee. Ini masalah dia.
Itulah.
Okey, tak apalah.
Saya kenal lah Jimmy.
Jadi ada jenama A dengan jenama B. Okey. Sebenarnya hari ni lagi banyak saya, bagi saya pengalaman saya kan, selalunya saya tak pakai sampai habis pun pen tu. Belum habis lagi dakwat dia, ball bearing dia dulu dah hancur. Itu saya kata tolak tepi ball bearing lah. Tolak tepi mechanical failure, okay? Dia macam mana?
You nak? Kalau saya lain macam ni. Kalau saya tak sempat habis dah hilang dah.
Itu memory failure. betul memory failure pada juga kan. Siapalah hari ni pakai pen sampai habis, aku pun tak tahu. Okey, pakai buang okey. Tapi the thing is, macam mana nak test? Ada nak apa tu, nak tarik panjang-panjang 10 km nak ukur, ataupun you all nak warnakan kertas? Oh, kira berapa kertas yang penuh diwarna, nak timbang air ke? Timbang isi padu, timbang air ke? Atau you nak timbang berat ke? Aku tak tahu. But you guys
saya macam ada idea lah. Saya rasa pen ni ketahanan dia tu berdasarkan ink lah, ink.
Yeah. Tolak tepi mechanical failure lah. Tolak tepi. Ha, kita nak.
Tapi kalau macam ink, ink tu boleh lah macam ni.
Tadi saya ink. Ah, so macam mana? Tapi adakah ink ni berbeza dalam dia punya density? Ada efek ke the density of the ink on the performance of the pen? Aku tak tahu.
Kalau dia punya tip tu boleh ke? Macam maksudnya larger tip, ya macam mata dia tu lah.
Bukaan dia punya
bukaan mata tu. Dia kecil ke kena, besar kena, ke?
Kenalah sama 0.2 dan 0.2 lah. Janganlah compare
0.2
dengan 0.8.
Oh,
kan?
Nak sama
lah. Ni kira apple to apple punya comparison
ni. Hey, eksperimen, kita kena control the parameters kan? Jadi apple you control lah. Control the parameter variable, jadi satu je yang kita nak test. Itu je. Macam mana kita nak design test ni? Itu. Apa nak design? Test apa kita nak design ni? Apa metodologi kita nak pakai? Tapi lepas kita laporkan, orang yang baca tu dia boleh duplicate tak your experiment following your steps? Itu pun penting juga.
Okay.
Teruskan. Nanti I come and visit you again, ya.
Yeah? Jasmine, body je kan?
Body je. Body je. Kau ingat kalau tulis daripada awal hingga habis, 2 hari pun tak habis. Benda, kita nak banyak kali kita berlatih, okey. Nah, ini saja nak memanaskan badan dan juga minda menulis. Okey, buat lu.
Alright.
Dia tak dawat atau putus-putus. So 2 minit sama
dia tak baguslah pen tu.
Yes. So ada kita kena nyatakan method tu. How we evaluate the quantity of the ink.
Itu dah kita dah analisis result lah, result daripada
ink aja. Itu saya kata tadi. Tolak tepi mechanical failure of the ball bearing. Tolak tepi.
Cik Azmi, maksud saya sekarang ni, sekarang kita nak compare dua ballpoint. Okay, so we need to put in the method. Okay, katalah dalam 10,000. Lepas 9,000 ballpoint A dah habis dakwat. So kita nyatakan macam mana orang yang evaluate that pen tu, okay, benda tu dah tak ada dakwat.
9,000 apa? 9,000 kilometer.
Circle.
9,000 circle lah, bagus. It must be duplicable, replicable. Nanti orang baca you punya method tu, dia boleh set up the same experiment.
So maksud saya, kita kena beritahu, okay, once the pen, the ink start to putus-putus ke, dah start, then kita kena beritahu lah di mana dia kena stop counting.
You define. Adakah ink tu putus-putus tu sebab mechanical failure?
See.
Itu saja, the ink. Adakah kita nak ukur isi padu ink tu? Dia nak timbang air ke? Aku tak tahu. I don't know. Adakah kelikatan? Kelikatan. The density of the ink play a role as well. Aku pun tak tahu juga. Tapi the parameters that you need to control. Adakah kita nak tulis, nak test ni, kita kena guna pen tu nak tulis atau kita keluarkan ink tu semua? Kita nak guna satu method nak test, aku pun tak tahu juga. Are you testing the ballpoint? Are you testing? Banyak benda fikir kan? Okay, tak apa. So that is why the design of the experiment is important. The design. Because you are designing an experiment to test what parameter. How macam scientific ni, scientific objectivity ni pun, kita kena control environment, control all the other parameters, nak test satu tu je. So how do you control your environment in your experiment? Contohnya, temperature you need to control. Nak test pen A dengan pen B, you kena test pada temperature yang sama. So kena juga ada method to measure the apa tu, the temperature kan. So to control
temperature.
Okay. Okay. Jangan fikir susah. Gelak-gelak je. No right and wrong answer. Macam-macam saya dah dengar, macam-macam idea dah keluar dah. Okay.
Alamak, cikgu dah masuk.
Janganlah risau. Maksudnya
dia dah cover semua faktor yang kat bawah tu lah. So kita measure dia dari segi berbanyak perkataan yang dia boleh tulis lah.
Yang
so, set dia punya volume sama dan kita compare berapa banyak word dia boleh write.
So kita masukkan juga dalam kita punya ni lah, eksperimen method lah.
Okay.
Cuma saya tak
tahu. Satu eh, nak ingatkan eh. Bila kita buat scientific experiment, you must control variable. Contoh itu saya kata tadi, are we testing the pen or are we testing the ink? Saya kata the ink. Itu saya kata tolak tepi the apa tu
mechanical
failure. Kan? So apa cara kita nak test ink ni? Supaya sama. Kan? You nak timbang berat ke, nak timbang isi padu ke, nak timbang air ke, you nak tulis straight line ke? Nak tulis perkataan, you kata. Perkataan kena perkataan sama. For both test. Lain kataan lain pula kan. Ada kata panjang, ada kata pendek. Ha kan. So you must control. Okay. Anyway, you are on the right track. Continue writing and continue discussing.
Sebab kalau macam kita nak tulis tu kan, takut wait
by 11:30.
Yes.
Cik Azmi.
Yeah.
Ada soalan untuk technical full report kan nanti?
No, tak payah full. Just the body je. I want to report on the design of the experiment and how you experiment. Jadi scientific experiment, scientific objectivity is bila kita design the experiment, we must know what are we testing. Itu saya kata tadi, tolak tepi mechanical failure. Because I'm not testing the ballpoint, I'm testing the ink. Jadi nak test ink ni ke mana? Nak tulis. Tapi nak tulis roller kena sama. Ball bearing ni kena sama ke tak? Kalau tak sama ball bearing pun can affect the performance, so your result. Temperature you kena control. Ada satu group tadi tulis tengok berapa perkataan tu. Dia kata perkataan you kena control perkataan apa. Ada perkataan panjang. Saturday panjang, Ahad pendek. Kan? Tak sama juga kan? Benda-benda macam ni lah. Alright. Actually there's no right and wrong answer. It's just for you guys to exercise your scientific acumen. Okay, your scientific mind. Okay. Jadi lepas tu tulis. And then nanti I will read your report and I will check for the grammar and check for the sentence structure as well. Eh? Okay. Okay, Faik.
So kalau boleh saya macam point Cik Azmi tadi, macam kita orang akan write instruction 1, 2, 3, and instruction tu basically on experimenting for difference of the type of the brand lah. Kan? But prior tu kita akan bagi tahu lah apa yang kita concern, apa yang kita.
Correct. You are on the right track. Okay. You're thinking like a scientist already. Okay, you're on the right track. Yeah.
Masa zaman.
Okay, good, Fai, good.
Okay.
Alright.
aku measure tu. To identify the initial.
Okay, guys. Nah, bagus. Design of the experiment.
Of ballpoint pens we used to write on other pages.
In fact, if you want it easier for your team members to read what you are typing, you can also enlarge the font, or you can also enlarge the size of the window. Yeah, correct. Macam tu lah, bos nak baca.
Kita nak buat sebatang pen je ke, Dr. Loh, ke ada banyak pen?
Kalau ikut metodologi ni, kena ada 2 pen setiap jenama.
Yes, setiap jenama tu ada dia punya repetition ke?
I think tak perlu kot.
Sebab dah mention 2 kat sini, ke nak buat?
Tak tahu, mungkin nak ambil 10 batang pen A dan 10 batang pen B, lepas tu ambil dia punya average value.
Dah, itu dah masuk statistical sampling pula tu dah?
Ya.
Okay. Tak ada masa statistical sampling pula dah. Aha. Okay, anyway, continue and have fun, ya.
Just bagi basic je kot. Basic.
Tu, apa ni? Apa, eh?
Dia drop point ke apa, kena ingat. Tu, nak tahu dia punya kepekatan dia kan. Tapi, nak kena Google kot sekejap.
Lagi selain tu apa, kita equipment biasa tu dia punya panjang lah kan, length je lah kan.
Yang length tu straightforward.
Sekarang kita memang kita nak directly tag, sebab memang apa, konsistensi orang lain nak tengok apa ni, ink ni dengan guna berapa length dia boleh tulis kan. Macam tadi 900 meter kan. So aku rasa kita maintain lah kot yang tu dia punya
aku rasa
parameter
tu
utama.
Itu min. Parameter utama lah. Betul lah tu.
Length ni nak ukur dengan ada alat tak?
Pemaris lah.
Pemaris.
Bagi apa? Tape.
Boleh pemaris, boleh. Ukur jalan.
Ukur jalan.
Ukur jalan tu yang tarik tape.
Saya teringat iklan. Macam saingan dengan Encik Afifi ke Dr. Afifi? Dr. Afifi eh?
Tak, belum lagi masih
ingat. Saya dengan Encik Afifi mesti ingat dulu kita ada iklan Kilometrico, ingat tak? Iklan
pen tu. Dia berjalan tadi habis tu.
Itu kena ukur jalan ke tu? kan? Tak apa, jangan sempat je gelak-gelak aja lepas tu tulis ya. Okey. Okay.
Boleh. Kita guna yang modern, yang civil punya tu lah, pakai laser.
Wah, pakai laser. Good idea.
Boleh juga.
Okay.
Cik Azmi?
Yeah. You're going to have our morning break now. So I'm going to call them back to the main room, yeah? Okay. I've just broadcasted to them.
Dia macam tak sama rata kan Cik Azmi bagi kat mereka tu.
Ada apa? Memang
ada
memang
ada 6 ada 4.
Yang ini automatic Zoom yang assign, not me. Jadi tak rata tu sebab apa? Dia termasuk dengan Puan Marina dan juga apa tu assistant Puan Marina sekali. Itu sebab room 5 tu ada 3 tu. Tapi kau campur Puan Marina dan assistant ada 5. Yeah. Okay, welcome back guys. Okay guys, welcome back. Kita rehat dulu. Don't worry, kita rehat dulu.
Belum siap.
Don't worry. Kita rehat dulu 15 minit. Rehat 15 minit. Okay, and then when we start again after 15 minutes, I will start and put you back into all the rooms again. Bilik yang sama.
Okay. Sure. Berapa tadi Cik Azmi?
Ah, 11.5 minit. Okay. Kita break for 15 minutes. Okay. And then I will put you back into your respective rooms. Jangan keluar daripada Zoom tau. Don't go out of Zoom. Because if you go out of Zoom, then I need to reassign you pula nanti masuk ke dalam bilik tu nanti.
Okay.
So just okay. Just pause, switch off your microphone and your camera but don't go out of Zoom, okay? Okay. So kita nak rehat sekarang. Okay. So kita rehat pun kena sungguh-sungguh. When I count 1, 2, 3, saya minta semua serentak untuk jerit. Nak rehat. Okay, masa dia.
Rehat.
1, 2, 3.
Rehat.
Okay, 11.05, come back, okay. Bila balik tu boleh buat kopi pun, bawa je kopi teh, apa benda pun, Maggie Mee tu boleh. Okay, kita lihat dulu ya. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Okey. Apa khabar semua?
Bagus.
Okey, bagus. Semua dah pulang?
Ya. Yeah.
Okey. Bagus. Saya terus hantar anda kembali ke bilik anda, ya. Bilik yang sama.
Oh, ada fatal accident.
Ni ISO 12757. Ha? Very good.
Email letak je Cik Azmi.
Ah, tak apa, hentam je. Nanti kita bolehlah cari yang betul punya.
Sebab tak pernah buat eksperimen pasal ni kan. So kita ni jelah.
ISO ke MS ke PS ke kan?
Haa. KMBR set the experiment control for the following test.
Ah, betul.
Kena buat ayat which is kita dah buat kan?
Ah, kita dah buat dah. Kita dah buat. Kita lapor okay. Kan?
Okay.
Bagus. Dalam semua kumpulan, kumpulan ini je yang ada parameter control for temperature, pressure, humidity.
Ah, terima kasih. Memang letak je.
Yang lain tu, yang lain tu tak perbincangan dia sampai ke laut pun ada. Okay, very good. Terus tulis ya. Okay, nanti aku akan make your room.
Boleh pun masuk kat Zazalina, angle of writing.
Ni pun external juga kan?
Ah, ya.
Of writing. Degree kan?
Oh, hebat ni. Ada Shrish lagi ni. Ah, bagus ni. Ini method nak keluarkan ink ni. Ah, dahsyat ni. Okay.
Kita buat je, Cik.
Yeah. Don't forget to control your parameters, yeah?
Aha.
Your test environment punya parameters tu kena control juga nanti, ya? Yeah?
Betul.
Aisyah back.
Ni, Cik.
Aisyah.
Aisyah yang tadi tu back balik sebab Aisyah buang semua.
Tak dengar saya.
Yang Aisyah back balik. Uh-huh. Yang tadi sebab Aisyah dah buang semua ayat.
Tarik yang dia first. Tu.
PowerPoint pen B lah. PowerPoint pen B. Dah ada off lah. The steps 1-4.
Okay, bagus. Continue.
Dia ada angle berbeza-beza kan.
Betul.
So mungkin nak buat garisan tu hilang lah apalah.
Tapi benda tu dia kena pakai robot lah. So robot dia konsisten lah.
Okay, high tech lah kitanya ni.
High tech lah.
Pressure. To the paper must be consistent.
Betul.
Jadi kena kira lah you punya force berapa. Apa measurement untuk force Newton ni ya? Newton.
Okay, data collection.
Okay, so okay, next kot. Data collection
Data ni based on kita punya parameter
tadi. Length. Dalam unit apa? MM kot. Millimeter. Okay,
kita kira, ya.
Meter lah kan.
Meter. Banyak sangat pula.
Meter boleh.
Lain, totally different.
Okay, perlu tak kita nyatakan dalam report tu macam condition pen tu sendiri. Maksud saya macam misalnya Raga cakap tadi, condition pen tu ink dia banyak sikit, perlu tak kita nyatakan dalam report?
The dimension
tube diameter and the length of the two so that kita dapat dia punya kata dia punya apa nama isi padu lah. So do we need to control that thing?
The thing is itu kita sebenarnya tak boleh control. So because the pen comes as it is. Macam tu kan? We can't change. Kita tak boleh let's say kita nampak tube tu satu tu smaller, satu tu longer. Therefore we cut the other one to become same size as this. That one is not fair because it just happened. This pen reliably, they have more volume. That is the dia punya apa tu? Dia punya winning advantage. We can state that properties lah. Kita boleh kata memang pun sememangnya pen B ni dia the tube the ink apa tu? The ink tube is slightly longer. Macam tu.
Kalau kita nak a bit detail, contoh maksud saya. Kalau kita katalah kita dapat satu isi padu pin A ni 2, pin B ni 4 and then kita dapat circle yang dapat di create by pin A ni say 800 circle. Contohlah. Okay. Okay. Tapi circle by pin B is 1000. Nampak seolah-olah circle B ni lagi banyak compared to A. Tapi kalau kita tengok balik isi padu dia, kalau kita tengok nisbah, ratio dia, circle to the isi padu is 800 divide by 2, 1000 divide by 4. So ratio dia more on pin A. Itu yang saya kata.
Maksudnya sekarang ni, kita kena masukkanlah juga kenapa kan. Sebab katalah kita kata brand A tu lebih okay, dia punya circle dia better than B. Tapi kita nak kena state juga kenapa benda tu dia tahan lama daripada segi volume or daripada segi properties.
Kita kan? Boleh nyatakan dalam bentuk ratio macam saya cakap tadi lah. Circle per volume. Maknanya 800, dari 800 bagi 2, 400. Sedangkan pin B 1000 bagi 4 ia 250. Per volume kan. So dekat situ ini dia bentuk result macam mana kita nak report the finding lah.
Understood.
Faham kan? Itu yang saya maksudkan. How we kita nak macam mana kita nak, apa kata, kita nak deliver kita punya finding tu atau
finding
punya
tak, achievement.
Yeah. Yes.
Betul.
Not totally just circle.
Nah, betul. Tapi tak apa, tak apa. It's okay. There are many methods. Bila ada pergi kumpulan-kumpulan lain, ada cara-cara diorang jugalah. Jadi cara berbeza. Cuma, make sure that it, your apa tu, your method is duplicable. Replicable. Maksudnya, kalau saya baca atau bagi pada kumpulan lain baca you punya method kan, dia boleh ikut step-step tu dan dia boleh dapat keputusan yang sama. Itu je. Yeah? Alright. Okay, continue.
Alright. Okay. So, artinya the, our end report tu when we...
Jadi saya.
Kenapa dia tulis network disconnect eh?
Angle of attack dengan flow rate meter. Okay. Bagus.
Aisyah yang network disconnect boleh hantar.
Tapi saya ada je dalam line. Maksudnya line okay.
You sedang buka file yang nak share tu, you tengah buka ke? Kalau buka tak boleh share, kena close dulu. Okay.
By the way, Cik Azmi nak tanya, group kami memang 4 orang je eh?
Yeah. Maaf eh. Saya bukan je, saya memang assign 4. Saya guna yang automatic assignment Zoom punya algorithm. Saya tak tahu dia algorithm ni macam mana dikira.
Oh, tak apa, tanya je kotlah dia yang missing. tak apa. Okey.
Ada semua ada. Jadi mungkin nanti kita kena boleh buat satu eksperimen juga. Apa tu Zoom punya algorithm dia apa nak assign kan. Okey.
Okey. Alright. Tak dengar suara
tak
saya.
Tak dengar.
Yang termizi bagi tahu tu yang simple tu, yang kita measure.
Yang ni maksudnya kita measure volume before.
Dan problem yang kita mungkin encounter mungkin masa tulis 10 pages tu ball bearing akan rosak lah sebelum you finish writing 10 pages.
Itu your limitation.
Yeah, limitation of the test.
Then, that's my experience also. The ball bearing will fail earlier than the ink running out.
Ya, yeah. So our design kita limitkan 10 pages sebelum dia run out, then using calculation to estimate.
Okay. So you estimate the loss of ink ataupun the difference, ya? Yeah? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Good idea, good strategy.
Boleh tak saya nak tambah? Kita guna writing machine untuk produce consistent writing stroke, speed dan juga dia punya pressure.
Best eksperimen tajuk. Title, ballpoint comparison testing.
Boleh?
Ballpoint ink comparison testing by mechanical apa pun, by counter apa benda tadi nama equipment tu,
circle counter,
by circle counter lah kot.
Perlu dalam tajuk kita perlu tak letak method,
letak apa,
tak payah tu
dia kat bawah,
tak dengar, tak dengar apa dia.
I think the other word that should be added there is the ballpoint ink longevity comparison testing. Artinya dia punya ke apa tah
tahan
longevity tu apa dia?
Ketahanan.
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 Kalau dalam kalau English tu longevity tu maksudnya berapa lama tu. So
ketahanan ni ada dua banyak maksud ni, ketahanan segi dia punya.
Itulah. Kena define lah apa maksudnya. Jadi you need to define what longevity is. Lalu longevity ni orang tua kan. Longevity kan. Okay, tak apa. Teruskan.
Tak apa, kita maintain goal plan in comparison testing. Nanti title ni kita akan halusi lah.
Yes. Just leave it at that.
Yes.
Nak letak tak method apa using circle counter equipment?
By itulah, by circle counter equipment tu kan.
Nanometer, okay. Boleh lah. Cik Azmi nak tanya.
Saya.
Apa beza problem encountered dengan limitation and parameter of test ?
Problem
orang confuse kat situ.
Okay, problem encountered tu kita ceritalah. Apa tu ball bearing failure while itulah kan, while apa tu while testing kan. Contohlah ball bearing failure contohnya kan, ataupun apa tu the structure of the pen punya failure ke kan. Okay. Jadi yang itu kita katakan the problems that you encountered while doing the experiment. Yang satu lagi tu limitation ni. Jadi kita kena set yang kita punya ni only valid for temperature between 31 degrees to between 28 degrees to 31 degrees. Contohnya lah kan. So that means below than that we haven't tested. Kita sini 28 kan? 28-31 kan? Jadi kita tak tahulah kalau kat Eropah tengah winter 0 degrees, we don't know whether this is still valid or not because we haven't tested. So that's the limitation.
Condition dia lah.
Condition dia. Ataupun kita boleh kata kalau tak limitation, validity pun boleh jugalah. So dia mesti ada valid for certain parameters kan? Contohnya the temperature ke, the type of paper ke, apa ke kan?
Okay.
Okay.
Kita buat yang Tamizi bagi tahu tu. Sebab tapi untuk dapatkan benda tu, kita kena make sure benda tu sama dulu. Sebab kalau tak sama, macam mana kita nak measure before dengan after? Sebab before tu dah lain. Maksudnya 100 gram, 100 ml, 100 ml B. So untuk measure yang B ni, kena make sure dua-dua adalah 100 ml. So baru kita boleh...
Ada metodologi dia nama spreadometer. Dia baru aku jumpa.
Belum. Yang ni baru tunjukkan.
Yelah. Putus. Tapi I baru jumpa. Ada metodologi pakai spreadometer. Bagus, very good. bagus. Good. Betul-betul extensive betul-betul in detail dengan siapkan cross section of a ballpoint lagi Okay, bagus. Okay, continue ya.
Okay. That's why saya letak kat sini siap-siap tadi kan, macam yang pertama yang belum
ni right.
Boleh mak?
Hello.
Hai.
Kita orang dekat warehouse tengok equipment.
Memang betul ada mesin nak test ballpoint ni
Ada. Bila Google baru tahu ada.
Ni alat dia.
Baru tahu.
Ni alat dia.
I pun tak buat research. I pagi tadi subuh apa lah test nak bagi dia orang ni. Fikirlah okeylah kita test lah ballpoint kan. Rupanya betul ada equipment for testing ballpoint. Okay, good. Dek dia test dia dia bob dia test dia punya quantity of ink ke dia test dia punya tu
performance dari segi line semua itulah.
Dia tapi dia tak test mechanical lah.
Mechanical kita semua constant.
Constant lah kan. Betul. Okay. Good. This is amazing. Okay.
We need to put to nyatakan dalam equipment listing ni the setting atau macam mana?
Okay.
Rasa reduce speed tu semua dalam metodologi kot.
Masa kita tulis lah.
Tapi kata kita nak tulis tak apa. Tapi nanti kita padam lah. Cuma sekarang ni senang nanti nak buat write up. Benda tu dah kat atas kan.
Maksudnya korang buat rig sendirilah.
Buat macam apa tu?
Orang panggil buat rig sendiri. Rig tu maksudnya you set up you punya equipment tu dengan pemegang dia apa semua.
Yeah.
Dia panggil rigging kan panggil eh. So you buat your own rig eh. Okay. Interesting juga ni. How do you control for speed tu?
Macam mana
you control for speed tu? RPS apa tu? Per second, round
per second. Round per second.
Yeah, tapi macam mana you control for the speed?
The circle counter has the ability.
Ada counter?
Anggap.
Machine.
The circle counter is a machine.
So kita just set.
Oh, the circle counter itu is a machine. You boleh setting dia macam tu. Okay.
Yeah.
Kaedah tu, I fikir macam mana yang you all nak control for the variable speed kan?
Okay. So,
okay, done. Ready to group.
Done. Kita done lah. Without the statistical part.
Statistical part. Oh, ini statistical part ni kena masuk apa QA department ni dapat statistical part ni. Statistical sampling. Nanti dekat Gilang. Okay, tak apa. Okay. If you want to write about statistical sampling, you can also do that. Yeah. Then we can have confidence level. You can construct your confidence level.
Google ni jadi pening pula. Tapi tak apa, kita janganlah tiru dia kan. Aku just nak bagi idea.
Dia nak tahu basis dia.
Mungkin kita cakap kita based on this data ke, sebab data ni valid aku rasa. Kita boleh cakap kita ada reference. Kita nak replicate benda ni.
Yes.
You mean betul-betul ada orang buat research pasal ballpoint ni. Serius?
Ada Jasmine.
Dia maksudnya ada orang PhD ballpoint lah ya.
Ni University of Reading je ni.
University of Reading, Reading.
Reading
sebetulnya Reading. Baru aku tahu ada Professor Pan ballpoint.
So boleh ke kita cakap kita replicate dia orang punya test method je ni?
Boleh. Because scientific inquiry you build upon previous knowledge kan. Jadi tak payahlah replicate benda yang dah ada. You don't have to reinvent the wheel kalau dah ada kan. Okay, boleh.
Okay.
Yang ni method ni rasanya dia memang fokus pada electron microscopy punya kaedah lah kan.
Kita boleh cakap kita record the writing on a standard paper surface using optical as well as spectroscopy.
Cakap close area ke nak cakap macam mana? Eh? Non-windy ke sana? Close room.
Okay.
Kalau
close room, close room ke clean room?
Mak, nak ni nak katakan tanpa ada angin.
Clean room kan memang panggil.
Apa?
Room.
Clean room ke close room?
Okey.
Takkanlah nak clean room pula.
Tak payah clean room kot. Close room is enough. Close room dia tak ber tak berangin lah dia.
Tak berangin.
It's not airy. In fact, itu pun betul. Kalau airy pun tak ada masalah kan.
By right, tak ada.
Ini tak apa. Ini you are just reporting the your test environment.
Yeah.
So, what's your test environment?
Anything, yeah.
Your test environment. Jadi bila kalau saya pula nak replicate, so I also need to test to use the same test environment. Baru dapat result sama, betul tak? Yeah. Ataupun I nak tukar. What if I change the temperature of the room temperature? Will it make a change? Will it make a difference? Tu my experiment pula kan?
Yep, yep.
Okay, bagus. Ini ya.
Room temperature biasa 25 lah kan?
5
Itu pada bergantung pada kita lah, kita atas gila berapa. So kita dah letak 16 pun apa? So guys, kita punya setting lah berapa. Close.
Interesting. You're using a robot writing machine, yeah? Okay, interesting.
Ada lagi kan? Apa ni?
Tak juga kan?
Ini pressure apa ni?
Environment pressure. Dalam bilik tu.
Tu dah ada dah tu? 25 darjah Celsius tu?
Itu temperature. Ni pressure.
Jadi yang
0.1 bar. So 25 degrees Celsius at 1 atmospheric pressure.
Yes.
At 1 atm.
Sebab kalau
luar tapi ballpoint function because of gravity kan. Dia bukan because of atmospheric pressure kan. Dia gravity flow kan.
What we mean is that the circular machine pun, it applies a certain amount of pressure on the paper. So if we are doing an experiment at a pressure which is greater, it probably influence, it is actually exerting more pressure on the pen than it should. That's what we mean. We think a lot, we think too much.
We take seriously about this experiment.
Ini baru betul-betul
gave it to the researchers jadi macam ni.
Ini bila suruh test bos saya, dah siap belum? Belum bos.
Siapa nak test dah?
Baik sangat nak fikir kan, belum bos. Sudah siap belum? Belum bos. Itu equipment order from Italy belum sampai. Okay, continue ya.
Okay, room temperature. Okay.
I think the environment pun dah cukup dah kot.
Dah cukup lah, ya.
Three times. Tiga kali kot.
Ada satu room tu dia nak control for atmospheric pressure. Ada bearing ke atmospheric pressure?
Betul. Sebab tak nak buat. So, boleh je kot.
Apa nak control for atmospheric pressure? So iPad ni dia punya function is based on gravity flow kan?
Tapi dia boleh juga kesan dia punya efficient tu. So kalau kita maybe kita guna tempat tinggi, altitude tinggi, dia mungkin akan reduce the efficiency of the plane lah.
Itu pula kan. Aku ingat cerita aku baca on the net. America astronauts discovered that their ballpoint cannot function in outer space. Jadi they spend 500 million, half a billion to produce a pen that can function in outer space without gravity. The Russians, they just use pencil. Yeah, the Russians lagi sah. They just use pencil in space. Tak payah pakai pen. Okay, bagus. Continue.
Machine setting.
Juga, okeylah. Lepas tu.
0.2 kot, senang. Sama juga. Sorry?
Place the ink into pen A, pen B ni kita buang.
Okay.
Kita tulis place the ink masuk dalam machine tadi.
Dalam speedometer tu.
Dalam speedometer. Place the ink into speedometer machine. Yang bukan speedometer. Macam into the flow rate and speedometer machine.
Okay. Aku tak tahulah group ni ada fikir ke tak. Tapi satu group tu. Dia nak control environment dia apa? Environmental parameter dia. Dia nak control atmospheric pressure. Aku tak faham apa benda nak fikir nak control atmospheric pressure. Ada ke? Pen works on gravity kan? The ink flow works on gravity kan?
Tak effect much lah on the
gravity flow. Jadi kadang kita kata dah overthinking ni. Macam sangat thinking. Okay, tak apa kata dia. You punya solution pun dahsyat juga ni. Okay, pakai apa tu plotter lagi ni. XY plotter. Bagus. Jadi ada consistency dengan stroke dia. Okay, good. Bagus. Continue .
Okay.
David.
Tak, saya punya ni hang ke tak?
Siapa? Hafiz . Okay, tak apa. Okay. So kita dah terlepas masa ni. Can you finish in 3 minutes? Okay. Tak apa. You don't have to be 100% complete. Tak apa. Yeah. Okay, so in 3 minutes, just come back to, I will call all of you back, yeah?
Dah okey kan semua.
Dah okey, then you can save this. Nanti apa tu send it to the chat box . I'll collect from the chat box. Welcome back.
Saya seorang.
Okay, tak apa. Okay, tak apa. It's okay. Tak habis pun tak apa. It's okay. It's alright. Because it will never finish. Because your mind, when your mind starts thinking of a problem, it will never end. Yeah, you will think of this, you will think of that. Then someone start thinking of controlling atmospheric pressure. Someone start thinking of controlling this, controlling that. Yeah, so it never ends. Yeah. Okay, tapi the thing is, I want to start look. I want to look at your report and I want to help you to improve your report. Itu je, right? Okay, so if you have completed, just put some final touches. Finish the last sentence. Finish the last word. Put a full stop, and then send it to the.
Send it to my chat box. Setting automation is under. Send ke?
Kena send. Send it to the chat box.
Kita group apa?
Nama group tak letak je sini. Kena letak ke?
Kena letak je.
Ini serup meeting 5 tadi.
Baik, kita berapa? 5
Ah, 5.
Letak nama ketua lah.
Ah, senang macam tu kot.
Boleh juga.
Apa ketua?
Apa ketua?
Penulis lah, penulis tu pun boleh. Wakil-wakil.
Asal je je, wey.
Ketua, okay. Ketua kumpulan tu Kaide lah.
Eh, Kaide.
Mana Haji? Tadi Afifi ni, pom-pom.
Eh, hey, anak kau kan dia belakang tu?
Ah, ya, yeah. Anak saya.
Cute-nya.
Letak nama Fifi.
Biasalah.
Letak nama Fifi.
Tak sempat proofread.
Ada orang kat pejabat ni. Aisyah. Puan Aisyah, you are working today.
Kena hantar dah. In
the office.
Saya masuk office.
Ah.
Cik Azmi, sebenarnya kejap lagi saya ada meeting. Saya minta excuse kejap eh.
Okay, boleh. Nanti come back ya, after lunch you come back.
Ya, yeah, sure.
Tu dah terima dah. Okay, saya download dulu kumpulan pertama.
Mana, aduh.
I know kita hantar sajalah, Nun.
Ya, tu dah masuk. Saya hantar sampai habis. Okay. Mana nak share? Oh, share macam tu je. Hah, network. Ah, kenapa disconnect?
Okay, so I will share screen, yeah. Anyway, I would like to say congratulations to all of you. Well done, Tania. Anda semua telah melakukan kerja tadi dengan penuh kesungguhan dan juga kecemerlangan. Yes. Okay, give yourselves a big round of applause. Tepuk. Bagus. Okay, jadi saya
tak tulis pun.
Tak apa. It's okay. Sampai mana pun tak apa. Okay. Benda tu sampai esok tak habis. Okay, so ini kumpulan satu. Alright. Apa ni? Berkaitan apa ni? Okay, design experiment. Okay, sebentar. Alright, so the weight of the ink of ball pen A, WA1, was measured to identify the initial quantity of both ink using the micro balance scale. Okay. A test was conducted by writing 10 pages using another ball pen A. Ada dua ball pen ya. The test was conducted using writing robot to ensure consistency of the ink output. The weight of the ink of ball pen A, WA2, was measured after writing 10 pages. The total number of pages for ball pen A was calculated by 10 pages times. Okay, the weight of. Okay, divided by. Okay, so before and after. Yeah, before and after. Yeah, okay. The steps were repeated for ball pen B. So you are measuring the difference. So tulis 10 helai. Lepas tu measure the weight loss. So this one 15.8. Okay. When the ball bearing was damaged before finish writing 10 pages, the test was repeated by using a new ball pen from the same brand. When the ball bearing was damaged before finish writing 10 pages, the test was repeated by using a new ball pen from the same brand. The following equipment were used in this report. Number one, micro balance scale, 10 robot writing machine. Okay, very good. So that means total pages, 20 milligram to write 16.6 pages. Yang ini 22 milligram to write 15.8 pages. So average, you kena, maybe you need average, yeah? Okay, then we will know what is the performance of the ink per milligram of ink. Okay lah. Siapa group one? Group one. Hello, group one. Group one.
Hello.
Can you tell me what is the average here? How many pages per milligram? Divided by 20, 16.6 divided by 20, 0.83, isn't it? 0.83 pages per milligram. Okay, so the next one is divided by 22. 15.8 divided by 22, you tell me?
15.8
divided by 22 milligrams.
0.72.
Okay. So after controlling for all variables, so we have a result here. So the ink for ball pen A, yeah, can last longer because it can write 0.83 pages per milligram as compared to the ink in ball pen B, which can only write 0.72 pages per milligram. Betul? Betul lah kan? That is the conclusion, right? So therefore the performance of the ink in ball pen A is superior to the performance of the ink in ball pen B. Okay, so you can write here the conclusion. Okay. After controlling for factors or variables, the ink of A had better performance Okay, yeah, lebih kurang lah. What is the exact number? 0.83, 0.72. So you can already conclude. Okay, so now you can conclude because you make the comparison based on per milligram of ink. Okay, so that is your group solution. I'd like to congratulate as well for writing using correct English grammar as well as a very good sentence structure, easy to be read. Okay, well done, group A. Group one. Okay, well done. Okay, tengok pula yang lain. Group one, group two. Okay, this is group two. Let me share screen. Huh? You see the screen? Okay, Encik Hafifi, ya. Yeah? Technical report writing problem statement to purchase two brands of ballpoint to report which brand last longer.
Yang yang bawah tu, Cik.
Last tu longer. Scientific theory. Bawah lagi.
Yang bawah lagi. Okay. Start daripada.
Okay, methodology to distinguish ball pen performance is based on return length. Based on return length, apa ni return length? Based on return length, usually the return length of average ball pen is 900 meters. The type of ballpoint pen used in the study okay, ball pen tak ada type. The bukan type, the brand. Ah, it's the brand. Type ni lain, type ni roller, ballpoint, itu type ya. Yeah? Brands of ball pen used in the study are pen A and B. We have used a machine. A machine test system to discover how far different brands of ballpoint pens can write. Each of these tests is conducted under the same conditions, which include the paper surface, downward force applied, as well as the writing speed and acceleration. The problems encountered from the test is to maintain the consistency of the material of paper, angle of pen under test, pressure to the paper, ball bearing failure or structure of the, and the quality of the ink. Data collected for the test is the length of the writing. This test is only valid under certain temperature and papers. Okay. Tapi tak ada keputusan lagi sebab eksperimen tak dilaporkan ya. Eh?
Belum siap.
Belum siap kan? Okay, tak apa. Okay, bagus. Everybody clap. Okay, belum siap tak apa. Dah banyak kumpulan lain lagi. Okey, kumpulan mana tadi tu? Group 2, okey dah group 2. Okay, group 5. The TNBR management considering. Is considering to purchase two brands of ballpoint pens. Please report which brand lasts longer. This experiment.
Tak share.
Okay. Belum share. Okay, saya share sekarang. Okay, the TNBR management is considering. Ya, ini saya tambah tadi ya. To purchase two brands of ballpoint pens, please report which brand lasts longer. This experiment has applied the ISO 12757 and ISO 14145 standards methodologies to determine the different performances of the ballpoint pen. Ballpoint pens. To complete the experiment within the project time frame, TNBR has set the experimental constant for the parameter below. For the parameters below. Table 1, constant physical parameter setup. Wah. Size of the metal ball, type of metal used, dye composition, color of the ink, ink composition, drying time of the ink, paper length, angle of writing, paper type. Okay, incredible, yeah. TNBR sets the control, the environment control for the following. Start there, for the following aja. For the following external factors. Temperature, pressure, humidity. TNBR has conducted the data collection as below. Repeatability, sample size, usage interval. TNBR experimented with the pen performance following the steps below. Set up the mini right XP as shown in figure 1. TNBR set the constant parameter according to table 1, table 2. Whew. Mini right XP. Mini right. Okay. Guys, look. There's a machine to test. The conformity of the pen was observed and recorded. All modified parameters were recorded by the machine as shown in figure 2 below. Pen and MiniRite XP setup. Step A to D was repeated by TNBR 3 times to ensure consistency. These parameters were then transferred to TNB MyCloud for data logging. TNBR extracted the data from MiniRite XP software. The data were analyzed using a statistical approach using SPSS. NBR determined the pen performance based on the length of time of the line created in clarity. Apa ni?
Tu tak sempat nak habiskan. Nak mention pasal clarity. Sebab walaupun dia performance dia lagi panjang, tapi kalau tak clear pun in terms of quality lah, maksudnya line created in terms of length and clarity tu in terms of quality yang line tu.
It is a bit confusing for you to put at the end eh. Okay, I will
say yes.
Tak sini, bagus tu. Depan bagus. Based on clarity and the length of the line created. Clearer that way kan?
Okay. Habis dah. Yang bawah ni our note je.
Habis dah?
Dah habis dah.
Okay. That means masih tak habis lagi lah. Okay, so... Okay, very good. Clap. Saya suka awak dah pecahkan constant environment parameter dengan yang satu lagi ni. Apa ni? Variable. What do you call this? Variable breakfast. Yang ini table 4, table 3. What is table 3? Tak, table 1, 2 ni semuanya pasal parameters, set up parameters kan? But I'm asking you, what is table 3 here? What does it mean? Parameter.
To our approach for data collection.
So all the data collected must be repeat, follow the repeatability, set up sample size, mesti usage interval, semua itulah.
Okay. Okay, good. Okay, very good. No mistake. Satu je ni. Okay. Okay, bye. Okay, bagus. Okay, let's go to the next one. Siapa lagi next one ni? Ada question ke? Chat.
ISO ni main letak je tau.
So that is the that's the message that you want to reveal. Eh? Okay. Hai, mana dia bunyi? Group 4. Okay, group 4.
Cik Azmi, yang group 4 tu ambil yang bahagian bawah.
Bahagian bawah. Okay. So, firstly, pasal aku nampak sini, in modern letter writing, kita dah tak tulis THNDRD dah. Eh. Surat pun tak tulis, email pun tak tulis lagi dah. Dia terus saja. 10.
Jun? Ini belum share ke?
Oh, I belum share lagi. Hai, dua kali dah ni. Okay, I'm saying here. I was saying. Dia tak perlu dah. 24th, 25th, 22nd tak perlu dah. Okay. Not required anymore. Not in modern letter writing. Eh. Terus je 24 Jun 2021. Eh. Okay. Question A. Question. Compare pen A and B. Which one last longer? Focus on inequality.
Azmi. Sir? Boleh ulang balik yang numbering tu. Macam mana ya?
Okay. Penulisan modern. Modern letter writing. Whenever you write email, report, letter, yeah, you can eliminate the use of THNDRD. THND, RT, ND. THRD, ND dengan apa lagi ya? ST, ND, RD dengan TH. Sebab dalam bahasa Melayu pun kita dah tak pakai HB lagi dah. Surat kita dalam bahasa Melayu pun kita dah tak tulis HB. Kita terus saja 22 bulan dengan tahun. Okay, sama juga. Single pun sama. Kita dah tak tulis dah. THTH ni tak ada dah. Itu style lama. Itu kata style apa? Style zaman Shakespeare. Sekarang tak payah dah ya. Okay, group 4. Question. Compare pen A and B. Which one lasts longer? Focus on inequality. The objective of this report is to compare performance of pen A versus pen B based on its. Okay, so here you see it's a mistake. Siapa yang betul kan? Ada betul kan ni? Okay. Based on this mistake, okay, ITS apostrophe, dia memang dah ada apostrophe dah. ITU, IT apostrophe S. Cuma tak nampak eh. Okay, this is to differentiate between it is and also it's dia punya kita punya. Let me give you an example. Okay. Siapa ni? Sazalina. Lives in suggest a name, please. Suggest a name, Sazalina.
Fani.
Bangi lives in Bangi. Lives in Bangi. Okay. However, she has to lives in Bangi. Okay. However, she has to work. She has to work in mana TNBR? Unit 10 eh?
Kajang.
Kajang. In Kajang eh? In Kajang. Okay. Alright. Okay. So apa tu bila kita apa nak kata ni? Bila kita compare ah. Okay. Bila kita compare, kita kena bagi tahu juga kita focus on what ya. So sini kita focus on inequality. Okay, so the answer, the objective of this report is to compare performance of pen A versus pen B based on she has to work. Tak betul ni. Saya nak explain itu tadi. Next sekali. Mana ya? Okay, it is. It is far. It is near. It is near Bangi. Okay, it is near Bangi. Okay. Jadi yang it is near ni kita boleh tukarkan kepada IT apostrophe S. It is. It is near. Okay, to show possession. Okay, to show possession, Sazalina has a cat. Okay, its tail is long. Jadi ITS bukannya IT apostrophe S, faham tak? Yeah, jadi yang ini is actually the apa tu contraction for it is. Yeah, it is a contraction for it is. Possession bukannya IT apostrophe S tetapi ITS. ITS banyak orang buat silap eh. Okay, so once more, objective of this report is to compare performance of pen A versus pen B based on its dia ITS saja. Bukan IT apostrophe S, it's in quality. The experimental methods used. Experimental methods. Dia ada beza experiment methods dengan experimental methods. There's a difference. Okay, experimental methods. Experiment methods refer to the method that you use for experiment. Experimental methods means that the method that you are using is experimental. Dia ada dua eh. Be careful eh. So let me explain to you again. Okay. Experiment methods. Okay, refer to kaedah yang digunakan untuk uji kaji experimental becomes adjective already. Okay, ini kaedah yang masih sedang diuji. So dua. So experiment methods kaedah yang digunakan untuk uji kaji. Experimental methods maksudnya kaedah yang sedang diuji. So you are testing the method. So are you testing the method or are you using the method for testing? Mana satu? Group mana ni?
Using the method.
So you are using the method. So using the method bukannya experimental tapi experiment, okay? Here is experiment, ya, bukannya experimental. The experiment methods atau the experiment methods ataupun the methods for experiment, okay, ataupun the methods for experiment used were ink volume test. Nanti bagus letak kat situ lah. Methods, the methods used for the experiment. Ini lagi clear. Experiment. Okay, so the methods used for the experiment were ink volume test, flow test, and dispersion test. Okay, jadi ada tiga kali test ni. Tak payahlah setiap test tu kita tulis test. Jadi, we just say were ink volume, flow, and dispersion tests. Descriptions on the methods are as follows. As follows. Ada S, eh? Okay. Ink volume test. Objective to measure the ink volume. Prepare pen A and pen B for the experiment. Take out the tip of pen A carefully using a plier. Using a plier. Macam mana je plier? Sekejap, eh. Aku pun kena check. Macam mana je plier? Plier. Pliers. Okay. Pliers ni ada S. Okay. Pliers ada S, eh. Using, dia tak payah E. Okay, terusnya using pliers. Okay, so there you're given a cross section a cross section of the pen. Okay. Take out the tip of pen A. But you need, take out the tip here. Okay, and when you write, you need to label all your pictures and your tables, yeah. So you need to label. So you didn't label. Tak sempat, ya, betul. Tak apa, saya labelkan. So you need to label, ya. Jadi yang ini kita boleh gunakan diagram. Diagram one. Okay. Section of a cross section of ballpoint pen, and then you need to refer this. Take out, but you didn't label, eh? So kalau kita label, kita boleh tulis diagram A using pliers. Okay. Prepare a 1 milliliter syringe as per image below. The incremental amount between the visible number is 0.1 ml. There are 9 smaller lines between each number. Since 0.1 divided by 10 is 0.01, this syringe allows accurate measurements as small as 0.01 ml. Apa ni?
Nak bagi bagi tahu.
Accuracy level.
Accuracy level. Okay. All right, I can see that. Okay. So this one. So this one you need to label also. Diagram 2. Okay.
Cik Azmi, 3. Is it? Ni kenapa kita guna diagram? Kenapa kita tak guna figure? Because yang first tu diagram okey lah sebab dia memang diagram. Tapi yang ni kan figure.
I tak adalah pula buat apa tu. Pembezaannya lah kan. Okay. Kalau nak guna figure pun boleh. Nak guna picture pun boleh. Kalau if you want to be really really strict about this, then this is actually picture eh. Picture one eh. Okay. So this is picture one. Because this is picture. Okay. This is picture. So kat sini lah. Picture one. Okay, thank you. Okay, make sure the plunger is pressed down to the bottom of the barrel. Place the tip of the ink. Draw back on the plunger and the ink will flow into the syringe. The markings on the side of the syringe indicates the volume of the ink. Record the volume of the ink. Make sure eyes should be in a straight line directly above the marking of the syringe to prevent parallax error. Waduh. Okay. Parallax error. Okay. Repeat step 2 to step 8 with pen B. With pen B. Okay, yang ini kita boleh shorten juga. Dah dua kali step. Steps 2 to 8. Okay, so I will strike out yang ini. Okay. Compare the ink volume of pen A and pen B. Pens A and B. Volumetric test. Objective, to measure the ink flow rate. Measure the ink volume of 0.2 milliliter from pen A and pen B. Pens A and B. Pens A and B. Place the ink into pens A and B. Testing was done using XY plotter as per figure below to control pressure and consistency of the ink. Okay. Yang ini ada masalah. Masalah dia gini. Yang ini the first two here is like an instruction. But the third one, this is like reporting what you did. Testing was done. Okay, so are you, so if you need to be consistent, if you're giving instruction, 1, 2, 3 instruction. So close instruction, the third one will be use XY plotter to control pressure and consistency of the ink. Jadi, to be consistent, so we don't say testing was done. Okay, so we say use XY plotter for testing as per figure below to control pressure and consistency of the ink. Okay, so yeah, ini kena label jugalah. But this is not figure. Is this figure or is this picture?
Different figure dengan picture. Macam sama.
Kan? Okay. So yang ini picture lah. Okay. Figure tu I will check later. But if I remember correctly, the usage of figure tu is for apa tu, macam diagram lah eh. Okay, tak apa. So this one also you need to label ya. Picture ke figure ke. Picture ke figure eh. Figure, okay. XY plotter. Measure the ink volume after test using method A. Record the reading. Okay. So here you are like giving instruction here, yeah. So I've corrected that number 3 tadi tu. Flow rate test, objective to determine the flow rate of the ink. Measure the ink volume of 0.2 milliliter of pens A and B. Pens A and B. Place the ink into flow and speedometer. Into a flow and speedometer. Speedometer ke spreadometer? Speedo.
Sekejap lah, cek.
Ah, tadi macam dengar just spreado.
Speedo.
Hah?
Sekejap.
Speedo. If I remember correctly, Speedo is the brand of swimming trunk. Tak gelap pun ya. Okay. Speedo ke spreado?
Spreado.
Ah, benda lain ni spreado ni. To measure the spread kan. Okay, spreado. Spreadometer, bukan speedometer ya. Okay, while you are at it, can you also check whether flow rate is one word or two words?
Two words.
Eh?
Should be two words.
Okay. Run the machine, record the reading. Okay. Okay, tapi you have not reported on the reading kan? On the reading, yeah. So we still don't know which ink will last longer, yeah, which pen will last longer. Okay, based on the ink. Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, later we settle the usage of picture, figure and diagram. That one later, yeah, after lunch. I want to make some references first. Okay, so the next one will be that one group Faik, yeah.
Group 3 belum.
Okay. Kejap ya. We'll break for lunch in a while. Okay. Hey. Okay, group 3. Hey, where's group 3? Okay, group 3 is here. Let me share the screen. New share. Group 3. Okay, ballpoint ink comparison testing. Comparison testing using circle counter equipment. Comparison bukan testing, comparison test saja. Objective to determine longer lasting ballpoint pen. Two different brands of ballpoint. I think ballpoint is one word here, yeah. Ballpoint, yeah. One point is one word, yeah. Okay, one word as well. Ballpoint A, ballpoint. Ah, ini tak payahlah ballpoint ulang balik. because you dah mentioned earlier tu. So remove the bullet point A and B. Two different brands of ballpoint pens, A and B. A and B. Okay, plain white A4 paper, 80 grams. Other specifications are assumed the same for both ballpoint pens, A and B. Okay, remove this one, okay. Self-set by the tester. Equipment, circle counter machine. Equipment was set based on the list below. Radius, 200 mm diameter. Speed, 5 rounds per minute, per second. Pressure, 0.1 bar. Okay, using a gauge. Control environment. The experiment was conducted under controlled conditions as below. Room temperature, 25 degrees Celsius at 1 atmosphere. Closed room, no major air movement. Method of testing. Tapi yang ini, be careful eh. The way you write this, people may misunderstand this as negative 25 degrees Celsius. Yeah, be careful. Okay, attach. Method of testing. Attach to ball pen to the circle counter. Set up the machine based on the setting machine. On the setting and environmental conditions above. Okay. Here, you are reporting. No, when you use a past tense, you are reporting. So here you are not reporting. So how to change this to reporting? You want to use reporting, yeah? So the machine. So here you remove here. So the machine was set up. The machine was set up based on the setting. So here now you are reporting. You are not instructing, but you are reporting. So results, ballpoint A. Ballpoint pen. Okay, ballpoint pen. Is complete circle drawn 100 for ballpoint pen B, 98. Analysis. Ada analysis lagi, okay. Okay, so ballpoint pen B drew less circles compared to two less circle compared to ballpoint pen A. Okay, so here be careful. Eh? Are you reporting what you did or are you writing instruction? Right? So don't mix up instruction as well as reporting. Okay.
Hey, Jazmi, should it be instruction or should it be in report like report style ke, or should it be instruction style?
Okay. Okay, so it should be report because you are reporting what you did. Okay, so you are reporting what you did. You are not giving instruction because if you give instruction, right, it may not necessarily mean that you did those things. You may give instruction a different thing. But what you did as an experiment was a different thing, but you did not report what you did for the experiment. Boleh faham?
If it is instruction, artinya kita kena follow exactly what is stated there. But yeah. if reported, for example here, if we say the machine was set up based on the need, how I set up, probably I took the machine, took on a table, put there and I said, or put it on the floor. So up to me how I want to set up, right? If I follow the reporting style, it doesn't clearly explain how the setup was done. Tapi kalau if I put in terms of instruction, we will say, you know, put it on the table on a flat surface ke dan sebagainya.
Okay, so, Mr. Raghavan.
Yeah.
What is a report?
Report speech means to tell what you did.
Itu je lah.
Okay.
You are actually reporting what you did.
Okay, so that's why I'm asking. Actually, so when we write here steps, should it be in the report style or instruction style so that the next person can follow it? Exactly.
Okay. Actually, it should be written in the reporting style. So you reporting. Should be reporting what you did for the experiment. What was the setup that you what was the setting that you used for the setting up of the experiment? Okay. So if another researcher refers to your report and he wants to replicate your experiment, he will have to follow the steps that you have taken. Instruction doesn't mean that you follow the instruction to that the instruction was followed 100% to set up the experiment. Okay, but when you report what you did during the experiment, okay, so that means you are reporting 100% what you did.
Okay,
so instruction is different. Instruction may not necessarily mean that you follow those instructions 100% when you set up for the experiment.
Okay.
So complete circle drawn. So this is reporting. So now you are being consistent here. Okay.
Azmi, nak tanya sikit.
Yeah.
A bit confused sikit pasal Cik Raga dia cakap pasal instruction punya sentence dengan reporting punya sentence. For technical report writing, is it allowable to buat macam numbering and point form macam ni? Sebab kalau tadi cakap, kalau contohnya thesis kita tak ada literature review, tapi for thesis we are not allowed to put numbering as per instruction punya sentence. Kita kena buat dia dalam para lah, okay. Paragraph, right? So, is it allowable kalau numbering in the technical report writing?
Technical report writing ni, orang panggil technical report writing, yeah, is actually, orang panggil is quasi formal. Dia tak ada formal macam thesis writing. Or semi formal pun boleh juga kan. Jadi maksudnya it is not 100% like a thesis. So the rules are relaxed a bit. Okay? So that is the first thing. The second thing is numbering versus point form. Numbering versus point form. So if you are describing a list of items, yeah, without any sequencing, okay, use bullet points. Okay, however, if you are describing a list of actions with sequence, so this one you must use numbering. So this is not academic writing. Okay so you can relax that and you can be you can be more concise. So now the difference between numbering and point form lah kan. So if you are giving a list of items without sequencing, then you should use just bullet points. Because the numbering indicates sequencing. Must do number one first. And then do number two. And then do number three. Tapi kalau misalnya shopping list doesn't require sequencing. So shopping list, you can use point form. Bullet point, yes, point form. Okay, so that's the difference. Okay, thank you very much for your question. Okay, so ada lagi yang saya belum sekejap eh. Group 3 sudah. Assignment group 4. Group 4 sudah ke?
Belum.
3, 2, 4 sudah. Siapa yang belum ni? 5 eh? 5.
5 dah. 5 dah.
5 sudah. That means finish already eh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah, finish. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've already finished. Okay. Okay. So done. Any question before we take a break for lunch?
Cik Azmi nak tanya soalan.
Ya, yeah, okay.
Ada tak macam buku reference yang kami boleh baca untuk subjek technical writing?
Technical writing, tak ada buku, tapi there are some guidelines which is on the internet. Yeah. Nanti I will give you some of the references.
Okay, thank you. Alright.
Tapi there is no single authority actually for technical writing. Sama juga macam thesis writing. Yeah. The format also depends on the university. Yeah. Your referencing as well. Your literature review referencing, the format also has you also have different format. Ada University of Chicago format, ada APA format, betul tak? Yeah. So that also you don't have a standard, or you have several standards. Okay, but the thing is to be consistent. So if you use University of Chicago punya referencing style, then you must be consistent until the end. Okay. You only use one style. So janganlah in one document you use several styles. So that's my take on formatting. And for all I know, Tenaga Research also have a standard format for reporting technical reports or writing technical reports. Okay, so I don't want to get involved into the formatting of your technical report. Okay, but I just want to improve first the way you write, and number two, I also want to improve how you report and what are the things that you report to make your report useful for other researchers. So the report is not for yourself. The report is for other researchers. So of course you yourself you will remember what you did. Oh, aku beli ni, aku ambil tu, aku pasal. Of course you will remember. But the test is if another researcher is to read your report, can the researcher replicate and duplicate your experiment? Nah, itu soalan dia. Itu soalan dia. Kalau dia boleh duplicate, bagus. Kalau tak boleh duplicate, that means we need to improve our writing. Okay, we need to improve our writing. Okay, so now 12:58 already. So we break until what time?
2:30, not sure.
So what time do we break? Until what time? 2:15? 2:15. 2:15. 2:15. Yep. Okay, 2:15, eh? Agree, eh? Yeah. Okay. So we break until 2:15. All right. So have a good rest. Have a good rest. I hope you have learned a lot today. Have you learned a lot this morning?
Yes.
Adara?
Yes.
Okay. So if you have learned a lot,
yes,
I am happy. Okay, in the afternoon, we will have another round of writing practice, and I'm going to share with you a few things. I will also look up the reference for the correct usage of pictures, diagrams, and figures. Tables as well. Okay, I also need to get the terminology correct. Okay, so let's have a break now. On your microphones, please. Switch on your microphones, on microphone. Okay, good. Okay, bersedia semua? Kita nak rehat ni. Apabila saya bilang 1, 2, 3, sama-sama kita ya, red. Nak makan. Boleh tak Afifi?
Boleh.
Okay. Faizal, Faizal on ya. Yeah? Okay, get ready. One, two, three.
Selamat
makan.
Dapur. Okay, okay. Have a good rest. Have a good lunch. We will return at 2:15 and we have another full day ahead of us. Yeah, a full afternoon ahead of us. Okay. Bye, Suba. Bye, bye, bye.
Bye.
Okay, bye. Bye, Nurul. Bye, Fifi. Bye, Mr. Raghavan. Bye, bye.